This message, Perseverant, was delivered on March the 5th, 1964 in Dallas, Texas, USA. Hierdie boodskap, volhardend, was gelewer op 5 Maart 1964 in Dallas, Texas, VSA.
Easily announce it so you can be sure to remember where it's at.
Kondig dit gewoonlik aan sodat julle seker kan wees waar dit is.
We want to read from Matthew, the 15th chapter of Matthew, beginning with the 21st verse.
Ons wil lees uit Matteus, die 15de hoofstuk van Matteus, vanaf die 21ste vers.
Then Jesus went thence and departed into the coast of Tyre and Sidon.
En Jesus het daarvandaan weggegaan en na die streke van Tyrus en Sidon vertrek.
And behold, a woman of Cana came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, Have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with a devil.
En 'n Kanaaneese vrou het van daardie gebied gekom en na hom geroep en gesê, Wees my barmhartig, Here, seun van David, my dogter is erg van die duivel besete.
But he answered her not a word.
Maar hy het haar nie 'n woord geantwoord nie.
And his disciples came and besought him, saying, Send her away, for she crieth after us.
Toe kom sy disciples nader en vra hom en sê, Stuur haar weg, want sy roep agter ons aan.
But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Maar hy antwoord en sê, Ek is net gestuur na die verlore skape van die huis van Israel.
Then came she and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me.
Daarop kom sy en val voor hom neer en sê, Here, help my.
But he answered and said, It is not meet to take the children's bread and to cast it to dogs.
Maar hy antwoord en sê, Dit is nie mooi om die brood van die kinders te neem en om dit vir die hondjies te gooi nie.
And she said, Truth, Lord. Yet the dogs eat the crumbs which fall from the master's table.
En sy sê, Ja, Here, maar die hondjies eet daarom die krummels wat van die tafel van hulle baas afval.
Then Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith, be it unto thee even as thou wilt.
Toe het gesê, toe antwoord Jesus en sê vir haar, O vrou, groot is jou geloof, laat het vir jou wees soos jy wil hê.
And her daughter was made whole from that very hour.
En haar dogter het gesond geword van daardie uur af.
Let us bow our heads now for prayer.
Laat ons nou ons hoofde in gebed buig.
I wonder tonight with our heads and hearts bowed if there would be someone here would like to be remembered in prayer.
Ek wonder vanaand met ons hoofde en harte gebuig of daar iemand hier sou wees wat graag in die gebed aangedink wil wees.
Would you just let it be known as you lift your hands to God and say I have a need Lord. I pray you will help me.
Sal jy dit net bekend maak soos wat jy jou hande na God ophef sê ek het 'n behoefte Here. Ek bid dat U my sal help.
Lord bless you.
Die Here seën julle.
Our heavenly Father, as we are now approaching thy majesty in the name of the Lord Jesus, for he told us if you ask the Father anything in my name, it'll be granted.
Ons hemelse Vader, waar ons nou U majesteit nader in die naam van die Here Jesus, want hy het vir ons gesê, as hulle die Vader enigiets in my naam vra, sal dit toegestaan word.
We come with all the faith that we have, believing that you will answer us according to our needs tonight, as they are many.
Ons kom met al die geloof wat ons het, in die geloof dat U ons sal antwoord volgens ons behoeftes vanaand, want hulle is baie.
Thou seest the hands of thy children throughout the building here as they raise their hands.
U sien die hande van die kinders hier deur die gebou heen, soos hulle hul hande opsteek.
And you alone knows what was beneath the heart.
En U alleen weet wat onder die hart was.
I pray that you'll answer them, Father, tonight.
Ek bid dat U hulle sal antwoord, Vader, vanaand.
They may ever desire that they have be granted to them this day.
En mag elke begeerte wat hulle het, vandag aan hulle geskenk word.
We pray for those who are unsaved, know thee not as their Savior.
Ons bid vir die wat ongered is en U nie as hulle redder ken nie.
We pray that they'll accept you tonight and find that all sufficiency that they must have in the hour of death.
Ons bid dat hulle U sal aanneem vanaand en daardie al genoegsaamheid sal vind wat hulle in die sterwensuur moet hê.
Many here maybe who has accepted you and has not yet been filled with thy spirit.
Baie hier miskien wat u al reeds aangeneem het en nog nie met u gees vervul is nie.
We pray that this night that thou will pour into them the abundance of the Holy Spirit that they might be servants to you in these closing hours of the world's history.
Ons bid dat vanaand dat u in hulle sal uitstort die oorvloedigheid van die Heilige Gees, dat hulle vir u diensknegte kan wees in hierdie sluitingsure van die wêreldse geskiedenis.
Heal all the sick and the afflicted, Lord. Thou knowest their need.
Genees al die siekes en beproefdes, Here. U ken hulle nood.
And we pray that your presence will come among us tonight in such a way that we'll recognize you as our risen Lord.
En ons bid dat u teenwoordigheid tussen ons sal kom vanaand op so 'n wyse dat ons u sal herken as ons opgestaande Here.
And when the service is closed and we go to our homes, may we be able to speak among each other, saying like those who came from Emmaus that day, saying, did not our hearts burn within us as he talked to us along the way?
En wanneer die diens afgesluit is en ons na ons huise gaan, mag ons in staat wees om onder mekaar te praat, te sê soos hulle wat daardie dag van Emmaus afgekom het, te sê, het ons harte nie in ons gebrand toe hy op die pad met ons gepraat het nie.
Or they were made to know you by a certain sign that you did before your crucifixion.
Want hulle het u herken aan 'n sekere teken wat u voor u kruisiging gedoen het.
And after you had risen, you were the same Jesus doing the same things.
En nadat u opgestaan het, was u dieselfde Jesus wat dieselfde dinge doen.
May we still witness the same tonight.
Mag ons steeds dieselfde vanaand aanskou.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
In Jesus se naam bid ons. Amen.
You be seated.
Kan maar sit.
I've taken my full time last evening on the subject of we would see Jesus.
Ek het my volle tyd gebruik gisteraand oor die onderwerp ons wil Jesus sien.
Then after having to introduce the caliber of the meetings and how to accept it is usually Brother Borders will to the strangers each night henceforth.
En na die kaliber te moes inlei van die bijeenkomste en hoe om dit te aanvaar, sal Broer Bodes soos gewoonlik vir die vreemdelinge elke aand.
I went my full time to 9:30 and I don't like to keep people waiting.
Ek het my volle tyd benut tot 9:30 en ek hou nie daarvan om mense te laat wag nie.
Just a few words to get acquainted and then the Lord words means one time him speaking mean more than anyone could say in a lifetime. Just one word from him.
Net 'n paar woorde om vertrou te raak en dan die Here se woord beteken. Een keer wat hy praat, beteken meer as wat enigeen in 'n lewenstyd sou kon sê. Net een woord van hom.
I wish to take as it was tonight a text from this scripture reading that God has given us here as a context.
Ek wens vanaand te neem as te ware 'n teks uit hierdie skriflesing wat God ons hier gegee het as 'n onderwerp.
May he give it to us.
Mag hy dit vir ons gee.
I want to take one word, perseverant.
Ek wil een woord neem, volhardend.
The word according to Webster on some notes I got written out here, it means to be persistent, to be perseverant.
Die woord volgens Webster op van die notas wat ek hier uitgeskryf het, dit beteken om aan te hou, om volhardend te wees.
And that is into making a goal, to be persistent, and that's perseverant.
En dit is om 'n doel te bereik, om aan te hou, en dis volhardend.
Man of all ages that has faith in what they're trying to achieve has been perseverant.
Mense van alle eeue wat geloof het in wat hulle probeer bereik, was volhardend.
No man can be perseverant unless first he knows what he's trying to achieve.
Geen mens kan volhardend wees tensy hy eerstens weet wat hy probeer bereik nie.
And you first must know what you're trying to achieve and then have faith that you're going to get what you are trying for.
En jy moet eers weet wat jy probeer bereik en dan geloof hê dat jy gaan kry waarvoor jy probeer.
And that makes you persistent, something that you know is real.
En dit maak jou volhardend, iets wat jy weet werklik is.
Faith is based that way.
Geloof is so gegrond.
Faith is not based upon a myth and upon something and well, just say go do this or do that on the words of some man.
Geloof is nie gegrond op 'n mite en op iets wat wel wat sommer net sê gaan doen dit of doen dat op die woorde van een of ander mens nie.
But faith takes its eternal resting place upon the word of the Lord, upon God's word, which is the Bible.
Maar geloof vind sy ewige rusplek op die woord van die Here, op God se woord wat die Bybel is.
Now we believe the Bible to be God's infallible word.
Nou ons glo die Bybel is God se onfeilbare woord.
We believe that it is the entire revelation of Jesus Christ, revealing himself in the Old Testament by the prophets.
Ons glo dat dit die hele openbaring van Jesus Christus is, openbaar homself in die Ou Testament deur die profete.
God making himself known through his son Christ Jesus, and in him dwelt the fullness of the Godhead bodily.
God maak homself bekend deur sy seun Christus Jesus, en in hom het die volheid van die Godheid ingewoon liggaamlik.
He was crucified for our sins, died, buried, rose the third day, and ascended into heaven, and is back here again in the name of the in the form of the Holy Spirit.
Hy is gekruisig vir ons sondes, het gesterf, is begrawe, het die derde dag opgestaan, het na die hemel opgevaar en is weer hier terug in die naam van die in die vorm van die Heilige Gees.
God dwelling one time God above us in Christ, God with us, now God in us.
God wat woon, eenmaal God bo ons in Christus, God met ons, nou God in ons.
It's God working his way back into man to worship, be worshiped through man, God's agency.
Dis God wat sy weg terugbaan in die mens in, om te aanbid, aanbid te word deur die mens, God se verteenwoordiger.
God does nothing outside of a man being his agent, his helper.
God doen niks behalwe dat 'n mens sy verteenwoordiger, sy helper is nie.
And now man who has had faith in God has been very persistent in what they're trying to do.
En nou het mense wat geloof in God gehad het, baie volhard met wat hulle probeer doen.
And we take men of all walks of life.
En ons neem mense uit alle lae van die samelewing.
For instance, George Washington here at Valley Forge.
Byvoorbeeld George Washington hier by Valley Forge.
After praying all night in the snow up to his hips, was wet way up around his waistline, and the river was full of ice.
Nadat hy heel nag in die sneeu gebid het, tot by sy heupe, was nat tot daar om sy middellyf, en die rivier was vol ys.
But he caught a vision from God. He caught faith that God was going to give him the victory.
Maar hy het 'n visioen van God ontvang. Hy het geloof ontvang dat God hom die oorwinning gaan gee.
And the river had couldn't have too much ice in it. Though
en die rivier het kon egter nie te veel ys ingehad het nie.
Over 2/3 of his army didn't even have shoes on their feet.
Meer as 2/3 van sy leer het nie eens skoene aan hulle voete gehad nie.
Their feet was wrapped in rags standing in that cold.
Hulle voete was in lappe toegedraai, in daardie koue gestaan.
But yet he felt in his heart that God had given the victory he had prayed through.
Maar tog het hy in sy hart gevoel dat God hom die oorwinning gegee het. Hy het deurgebid.
Next day we know 3 musket bullets went through his coat without touching him.
Die volgende dag weet ons, het 3 geweerkoels deur sy jas gegaan sonder om hom te raak.
The river couldn't stop him, neither could a musket bullet stop him.
En die rivier kon hom nie stop nie, ook kon 'n geweerkoel hom nie stop nie.
He was persistent because he had prayed through.
Hy het volhard omdat hy deur gebid het.
When he had faith in what he was doing and the one that was leading him, that was God.
En hy het geloof gehad in wat hy gedoen het, in die een wat hom gelei het, wat God was.
Nothing's going to stop a man when he's perseverant, when he knows what he's doing and got faith in what he's trying to achieve.
Niks gaan 'n mens keer as hy volhardend is, wanneer hy weet wat hy doen en geloof het in wat hy probeer bereik nie.
One of the oldest stories in the Bible, one of them was Noah.
Een van die oudste verhale in die Bybel, een van hulle was Noah.
Noah was just not some different man, he was an ordinary man, perhaps a farmer.
Noah was nie net 'n ander soort mens nie, hy was 'n gewone mens, miskien 'n boer.
And the world was wicked as it is today, full of science and great man.
En die wêreld was boos, soos dit vandag is, vol wetenskap en groot manne.
They had sprung from the sons of Cain.
Hulle het ontstaan uit die seuns van Kain.
The sons of Seth were humble shepherds, farmers.
Die seuns van Seth was nederige herders, boere.
But the sons of Cain were wise men, builders and inventors and scientists, real smart, real religious.
Maar die seuns van Kain was wyse manne, bouers en uitvinders en wetenskaplikes, werklik slim, werklik godsdienstig.
And they had their own form of godliness, but was denying, as it is today, the power of God.
En hulle het hul eie vorm van goddelikheid gehad, maar het, soos dit vandag is, die krag van God ontken.
And Noah, being a just man before God, one day God met him in the fields and talked to him and told him to build an ark because he was going to destroy the world with water.
En Noah, synde 'n regverdige man voor God, het God hom op 'n dag in die veld ontmoet en met hom gepraat en vir hom gesê om 'n ark te bou, want hy gaan die wêreld met water vernietig.
Now that was absolutely contrary to all scientific measurements of that day.
Nou dit was absoluut teenstrydig met al die wetenskaplike metings van daardie dag.
See, it had never rained. There was no moisture in the air.
Sien, dit het nog nooit gereën nie. Daar was geen vog in die lug nie.
And God had watered the earth through irrigation up through the earth with springs.
En God het die aarde bevochtig deur besproeiing, deur die aarde op met fonteine.
And there was no water for such. No water in the skies.
En daar was geen water daarvoor nie. Geen water in die lug nie.
Science in that day were probably more able, they achieved more than they are able to explain today.
Wetenskap in daardie dag was waarskynlik tot meer in staat. Hulle het toe meer bereik as wat hulle vandag kan verklaar.
They built the pyramids in Egypt, the Sphinx.
Hulle het die piramides in Egipte gebou, die Sphinxe.
They can never build that again. Those stones that high in the air, we haven't got nothing to put it up there with or no power to lift it.
Hulle kon dit nooit weer bou nie. Daardie stene so hoog in die lug. Ons het niks om dit daar bo mee te sit, of geen krag om dit te lig nie.
But somehow they were able to accomplish it in the days of Enoch and Noah before the flood.
Maar op een of ander manier was hulle in staat om dit reg te kry in die dae van Henog en Noag voor die vloed.
And perhaps they shot the moon and might have had astronauts and so forth. We don't know.
En dalk het hulle die maan geskiet en kon dalk ruimtevaarders gehad het en sovoorts, ons weet nie.
But Jesus said, as it was in the days of Noah, a great smart civilization, as it was then, so will it be at the coming of the Son of Man.
Maar Jesus het gesê, soos dit was in die dae van Noah, 'n groot slim beskawing, soos dit toe was, so sal dit wees met die koms van die Seun van die Mens.
And now, perhaps they, in their scientific research, they found something there that they could make a color and that would last till today, a dye of some sort, that would not give away.
En nou het hulle miskien, in hul wetenskaplike navorsing, het hulle iets daar gekry, sodat hulle 'n kleur kon maak, wat tot vandag sou hou. 'N kleurstof van een of ander soort, wat nie sal vergaan nie.
And they could embalm a body, make a mummy, that would look quite natural.
En hulle kon 'n liggaam balsem, 'n mummy maak wat heel natuurlik sou lyk.
Yet today, after 4,000 years, they still look natural.
Selfs vandag, na 4,000 jaar, lyk hulle steeds natuurlik.
We couldn't do that if we had to. We have nothing to do it with. We've lost the art.
Ons sou dit nie kon doen as ons moes nie. Ons het niks om dit meer te doen nie. Ons het die kuns verloor.
Many great arts that they had.
Baie groot kunste wat hulle gehad het.
No doubt they had instruments that would prove there was no water in the air.
Sonder twyfel het hulle instrumente gehad wat kon bewys daar is geen water in die lug nie.
And this man coming around contrary to science and says that there's going to come water out of the heavens.
En hierdie man kom daaraan teenstrydig met die wetenskap en sê dat daar gaan water uit die hemel kom.
Now the science could take an instrument and shoot up in the air and say, look here, Noah, read this instrument.
Nou, die wetenskap kon 'n instrument vat en in die lug opskiet en sê, kyk hier, Noah, lees hier die instrument.
It gives on this barometer here whether there's any water up there or not, and there is none.
Dit gee op hierdie barometer hier of daar enige water daarbo is of nie, en daar is niks.
Now you say it's up there and yet the scientific research shows that it's not there.
Nou jy sê dis daarbo en tog wys die wetenskaplike navorsing dat dit nie daar is nie.
That didn't stop Noah. He was persistent.
Dat het Noah nie gestop nie. Hy het volhard.
He knew that God had said it's going to rain and God was able to put rain up there if he said so.
Hy het geweet dat God gesê het dit gaan reën en God was in staat om reën daarbo te plaas. As hy so gesê het,
he would make it whether there was any there or not.
Hy sou dit maak of dit daar was of nie.
So he was persistent after he knew the word of the Lord.
So hy het volhard nadat hy die woord van die Here geken het.
And when a man knows the word and will of God, you become persistent. You become perseverant.
En wanneer 'n mens die woord en die wil van God ken, hou jy vol, raak jy volhardend.
No matter what science says, well, they can't do this, they cannot do that, you know it anyhow.
Maak nie saak wat die wetenskap sê nie. Wel, hulle kan dit nie doen nie. Hulle kan dat nie doen nie. Jy weet dit in elk geval.
You've got a hold of something and that something's got a hold of you.
Jy het iets beet gekry en daardie iets het jou beet gekry.
You're rotating together.
Julle roteer saam.
There's something about it that you cannot explain it.
Jy, daar is iets daarin wat jy dit nie kan verduidelik nie.
No matter how scientific it seems to be untrue, yet there's something in it that tells you that it's God.
Hallelujah.
There's nothing going to stop it.
Maak nie saak hoe wetenskaplik dit skynbaar onwaar is nie. Tog is daar iets daarin wat vir jou sê, dis God. En daar is niks wat dit gaan stop nie.
So we find that Noah pounded right ahead on the ark. No matter how much scientific proof it wasn't so and there was no rain.
So ons vind dat Noah net voortgehammer het aan die ark, ongeag hoeveel wetenskaplike bewyse. Dis nie so nie en daar is nie reën nie.
And he believed it anyhow because he had heard the word of the Lord.
En hy het dit nogtans geglo omdat hy die woord van die Here gehoor het.
And there's where faith is solemnly based upon thus saith the Lord.
En dit is waarop geloof plegtig gebaseer is, so spreek die Here.
Moses, another great smart man that had been raised up, born in the world for a certain achievement of God.
Moses, 'n ander groot slim man wat opgestaan het in die wêreld gebore is vir 'n bepaalde doelwit van God.
And he tried to meet this goal by his scientific acts.
En hy het hierdie doel probeer bereik deur sy wetenskaplike dade.
We are taught and told by history that he was a great military leader.
Ons word geleer en vertel deur die geskiedenis dat hy 'n groot militêre leier was.
And his only way of doing anything was killing off.
En sy enigste manier om enigiets te doen was doodmaak.
He was so smart that he could teach the smart Egyptians wisdom.
Hy was so slim dat hy die slim Egiptenare wysheid kon leer.
And all of his wisdom and all that he knew, yet he failed, miserably failed to achieve what God had in mind for him to do.
En al sy wysheid en alles wat hy geweet het, het hy nogtans misluk, klaaglik misluk, om te bereik wat God vir hom in gedagte gehad het om te doen.
And in finding his failure by slaying the Egyptian and hiding him in the sand and hearing the rebuke from his brother, or the question, will you slay us as you did the Egyptian?
In die vind van sy mislukking, deur die Egiptenaar dood te slaan en hom in die sand te begrawe, en die antwoord van die verwyt van sy broer, of die vraag, sal jy ons doodslaan soos jy met die Egiptenaar gedoen het?
Upon this, Moses ran into the wilderness, a runaway prophet.
Daarop het Moses in die woestijn ingehardloop, 'n wegloper profeet.
After 40 years in the wilderness that God had uneducating him from the things of the world unto the mind of God.
Na 40 jaar in die woestijn, wat God hom van die dinge van die wereld ontleer het tot die gedagte van God.
Taking all of his doctor's degree and everything away from him till he could work into his heart.
Alles van sy doktorsgraad en alles van hom af weggeneem totdat hy in sy hart kon werk.
When he had the material about ready one day while he was herding sheep on the backside of the desert, an old familiar path, he found a tree on fire.
Toe hy die materiaal omtrent gereed gehad het, eendag terwyl hy skape opgepas het aan die agterkant van die woestyn, 'n ou bekende pad, het hy 'n boom aan die brand gekry.
Moses being a scientist, he never approached it in the way of a scientist.
Moses, synde 'n wetenskaplike, het dit echter nooit benader op die wyse van 'n wetenskaplike nie.
If you'll notice, if he had been a scientist, he'd said, now I'm going to take some of the leaves from that tree and take them down to the laboratory and find out what they were sprayed with, the reason they burn and don't burn up.
As julle sal oplet, as hy 'n wetenskaplike was, sou hy gesê het, nou, ek gaan 'n klompie van die blare van daardie boom vat en hulle daar na die laboratorium neem en uitvind waarmee hulle bespuit is, waarom hulle brand en nie uitbrand nie.
If he would have done that, then he wasn't ready yet.
As hy dit sou gedoen het, was hy nog nie gereed nie.
But what he did, he approached it and took off his shoes, knelt upon his knees and began to talk to it because he knew it was supernatural.
Maar wat hy gedoen het, hy het dit genader en sy skoene uitgetrek, gekniel op sy knieë en daarmee begin praat, want hy het geweet dit was bo natuurlik.
From there came the word of the Lord saying, I've heard the groans of my people and I remember my word. I'm sending you down to deliver them.
Daarvandaan het die woord van die Here gekom, gesê, ek het die gekreun van my volk gehoor en ek het my woord onthou. Ek stuur jou daarin om hulle te verlos.
Now sometimes in the path of duty, God causes man to do things that's absolutely ridiculous to the natural mind.
Nou soms, as deel van sy pligte, roep God sy man om dinge te doen wat absoluut belaglik is vir die natuurlike verstand.
He causes them to do something that's altogether becomes a laughing stock.
Hy noodsaak hulle om iets te doen wat totaal 'n voorwerp van bespotting word.
For instance, what if Moses had failed as a young man, as 40 years old, a military man, and the throne his foot upon it, all the armies of Egypt under his control?
Byvoorbeeld, wat daarvan as Moses misluk het, as 'n jong man van 40 jaar oud, 'n militêre man, en die troon, sy voet daarop, al die leers van Egipte onder sy beheer.
And had failed doing that, and here he goes down to Egypt the next morning after meeting this angel in the bush with nothing in his hand but an old crooked stick from off the desert.
En om te misluk om dit te doen. En hier gaan hy daar na Egypte toe die volgende oggend nadat hy hierdie engel in die bos ontmoet het met niks in sy hand behalwe 'n ou krom stok uit die woestyn uit.
With his wife sitting on a mule and Gershom on her hip, the white beard hanging way down on his waistline, perhaps he's 80 years old.
Met sy vrou, wat op 'n muil sit, en Gershom op haar heup, die wit baard, wat dalk afhang daar tot op sy middellyf. Hy was 80 jaar oud.
His bald head shining to the sun, and a stick in his hand, his eyes set towards the skies, a smile across his lips.
Sy bleskop blink in die son, en 'n stok in sy hand, sy oë gerig na die lig, en 'n glimlag oor sy lippe.
Somebody might say, Moses, where are you going?
Iemand sou kon sê, Moses, waar gaan jy heen?
He said, I'm going down to Egypt to take over.
Het gesê, ek gaan daar na Egypte toe om oor te neem.
When he couldn't do it with an army, how is he going to do it with a crooked stick?
As hy dit nie met 'n leer kon doen nie, hoe gaan hy dit met 'n krom stok doen?
Oh man, you've lost your mind. You're out of your head.
Oh man, jy het jou verstand verloor. Jy's van jou kop af.
It was a one-man invasion.
Dit was 'n een-man inval.
But the thing of it was, he did it.
Amen.
Because that it was a word of the Lord.
Maar die eintlike ding was, hy het dit gedoen omdat dit 'n woord van die Here was.
And Moses was determined, no matter what his odds was, God was with him and he's worth more than all the odds.
En Moses was vasbeslote, ongeag wat sy kanse was. God was met hom en hy is meer werd as al die kanse.
Men and women could only think that tonight, that the word of the Lord is truth. There's nothing else.
As mans en vroue maar net dit kan dink vanaand, dat die woord van God waarheid is. Daar is niks anders nie.
All eternity hinges on the word.
Die hele ewigheid hang van die woord af.
Not one word Jesus said will fail. Heavens and earth will, but it won't.
Nie een woord het Jesus gesê sal faal nie. Hemele en aarde sal, maar dit sal nie.
Moses went down.
Moses is daarin.
And he was very persistent when he threw down his rod and it turned into a serpent.
En hy was baie volhardend toe hy sy staf neergegooi het en dit in 'n slang verander het.
Then he found impersonators.
Toe het hy nabootsers gekry.
That still lingers along the path of God. Someone to try to impersonate something.
Dat vertoef nog langs die pad van God. Iemand wat iets probeer naboots.
And the impersonators come up to make a show out of it. Threw down their rods.
En die nabootsers het nader gekom om 'n vertoning daarvan te maak. Hulle stawwe neergegooi.
Moses knowed who he had talked to.
Moses het geweet met wie hy gepraat het.
He knowed who he had believed and he was persuaded that he is able to keep that which he committed to him against the hour.
Hy het geweet wie hy geglo het en hy was oortuig dat hy in staat was om dit wat hy aan hom toevertrou het na te kom teenoor die uur.
Moses stood still.
Moses het stil gestaan.
Then the serpent of Moses eat up the serpent of the magicians.
Toe die slang van Moses, die slang van die towenaars opgeëet.
And we're taught that that same thing will repeat again, maybe not in the same manner, but it'll repeat again in the last days.
En ons word geleer dat daar dieselfde ding weer sal herhaal. Miskien nie op dieselfde manier nie, maar dit sal in die laaste dae herhaal.
For as Jambres and Jambres withstood Moses, so will they resist the truth.
Want soos Jannes en Jambres Moses weerstaan het, so sal hulle die waarheid weerstaan.
Moses was persistent, for he had an achievement with thus saith the Lord behind it, I'll be with you.
Moses het volhard, want hy het iets bereik met so spreek die Here daarachter, ek sal met jou wees.
David, standing before Saul one day.
David het voor Saul gestaan op 'n dag.
And he heard a Goliath come out over on the hill, a great giant that had 14-inch fingers.
En hy het 'n Goliath hoor aankom daar oor die heuwel, 'n groot reus wat 14 duim vingers gehad het.
And a great spear in his hand the size of a weaver's needle, probably 20 or 30 feet, big spear on the end of it, a tip of brass.
En 'n groot spies in sy hand, die grootte van 'n weewerbalk, waarskynlik 20 of 30 voet. Groot spies aan die punt daarvan of punt geelkoper.
Just imagine what that man's head would have been. It would have been the size of a tub with a big 2-inch thick helmet over the top of it and brass all covered up.
Dink net wat daardie man se kop moes wees. Dit moes die grootte van 'n balie gewees het met 'n groot 2-duim dik helm daarbo oor en geelkoper heeltemal bedek.
And he is making a challenge against the armies of God. And he said it in the presence of David.
En hy het 'n uitdaging aan die leers van God gerig. En hy het dit in die teenwoordigheid van David gesê.
And David was a little ruddy man. Little fellow probably stoop-shouldered.
En David was 'n klein, dingerige mannetjie, klein kereltjie, waarskynlik met hangskouers.
The Bible said he was ruddy, little fellow.
Die Bybel het gesê hy was dingerig, 'n klein kereltjie.
Never had no training in the and dueling with spears and things.
Het nooit enige opleiding gehad in twee gevegte met spiese en dinge nie.
But he had been keeping sheep out on the backside of the desert And a lion come in and got one of his lambs, and he went after him and slew him with a slingshot.
Maar hy het skaap opgepas daar aan die agterkant van die woestyn. En 'n leeu het ingekom en een van sy lammers gevang. En hy het hom agterna gesit en hom doodgemaak met 'n slingervel.
We find a bear did try the same thing and David overcome him.
Ons vind 'n beer het dieselfde ding probeer en David het hom oorwin.
And then David said, "Will you stand and let that uncircumcised Philistine defy the armies of the living God?"
En toe het David gesê, "Sal julle staan en toelaat dat daardie onbesnede Filistyn die leers van die lewende God uitdag?"
He shamed his brothers while they said he was naughty and come out to see the battle.
Hy het sy broers skaam gemaak terwyl hulle gesê het hy was stout. Hy het gekom om die geveg te sien.
Yet there was something in David. Yes. That he knew that he was more than a conqueror.
Toch was daar iets in David dat hy geweet het dat hy meer as 'n oorwinnaar was.
So he said, "If you're afraid to fight him, I'll go fight him."
Toe het hy gesê, "As jy bang is om teen hom te veg, sal ek teen hom gaan veg."
Saul this coming to the general Saul and he put his armor up on him and it wouldn't fit him.
Saul dit het by die generaal Saul uitgekom. En hy het sy harnas vir hom aangetrek en dit wou hom nie pas nie.
He found out that his ecclesiastical vest didn't fit a man of God.
Hy het uitgevind sy kerklike kleed het 'n man van God nie gepas nie.
And the thing didn't he didn't know what to do.
En die ding het nie. Hy het nie geweet wat om te doen nie.
This, I've never proved this. I know nothing about these bachelors of art and so forth.
Hierdie. Ek het dit nog nooit bewys nie. Ek weet niks hiervan nie. Baccalaureus, artium en so voorts.
Take the thing off of me and let me go in the way that God give me deliverance. Amen. Let me go with a slingshot.
Haal die ding van my af en laat my gaan op die wyse wat God vir my uitkoms gee. Laat my met 'n slingervel gaan.
While they said he's a warrior from his youth and you're nothing but a youth.
Wel, het hulle gesê, hy is 'n vechter van sy jeug af en jy is maar net 'n jongeling.
He said I'm more than a match for him. Let me go.
Hy het gesê, ek is meer as opgewasse teen hom. Laat my gaan.
And no matter how big the giant looked and how unreal it seemed to be, David was persistent. That uncircumcised Philistine wasn't going to defy the armies of the living God that he represented.
En maak nie saak hoe groot die reus gelyk het nie, hoe onwerklik dit skynbaar was nie. David het volgehou dat daardie onbesnede Filistyn nie die leers van die lewende God wat hy verteenwoordig het, gaan uitdag nie.
Oh, if we had more Davids in this army.
O, het ons maar meer Davids in hierdie leer gehad.
We had more men who would stand and be persistent, perseverant in the faith that was once delivered to the saints.
Het ons maar meer manne gehad wat sal staan en volhard in die geloof wat eenmaal oorgelewer was aan die heiliges.
Samson, another man, very perseverant.
Samson, 'n ander baie volhardende man.
He was born a Nazarite birth.
Hy was 'n Nazareener van geboorte.
A Nazarite means separated to the word.
'N Nazareener beteken afgesonder vir die woord.
What a nice thing it would be tonight if all Christians would be Nazarites to the Lord.
Wat 'n mooi ding sou dit nie vanaand wees as alle Christene Nazareeners vir die Here sou wees nie.
Separated not to creeds but to the word.
Afgesonder nie vir geloofsbelijdenisse nie, maar vir die woord.
Christ is that word. Amen. Separated to the word.
Christus is daardie woord. Afgesonder vir die woord.
He had 7 locks of hair that hung down his back which was a sign that he was separated.
Hy het 7 lokke hare gehad wat teen sy rug afgehang het, wat die teken was dat hy afgesonder was.
And then one day he was met out on the plains without anything in his hand to fight with by 1,000 Philistines.
En toe op 'n dag is hy teengekom op die vlaktes met niks in sy hand om mee te veg nie deur 1,000 Filistyne.
Those Philistines were men like a brass wall.
Daardie Filistyne was manne soos 'n geel koper muur.
Great heavy helmets over their heads, great armors up in front of them and shields, bucklers and so forth on. To dodge any bullet.
Groot swaar helms oor hulle koppe, groot harnasse voor hulle en skilde, klein skilde en so voorts aan om enige koel te ontwyk.
Probably the helmet being an inch thick upon their heads.
Waarskynlik met die helm 'n duim dik op hulle koppe.
Samson had nothing, but he still could feel that the promise that God made him was still hanging on his head.
Samson het niks gehad nie, maar hy kon steeds voel dat die belofte wat God vir hom gemaak het, nog steeds aan sy kop hang.
He could still feel the anointing, in other words.
Hy kon die salwing steeds voel, met ander woorde.
He knew that God was with him, for he felt them locks hanging out around his shoulders.
Hy het geweet dat God met hom was, want hy het daardie lokke om sy skouers gevoel afhang.
He grabbed what was in his confine, and it was a jawbone of a mule.
Hy het gegryp wat in sy hy kon vind, en dit was 'n esels kakebeen.
And he stood with that in his hand and was persistent that it wouldn't be the jawbone or his own arm, but it would be the power of the Lord.
En hy het daarmee in sy hand gestaan en het volgehou dat dit nie die kakebeen of sy eie arm sou wees nie, maar dit sou die krag van die Here wees.
And the power of the Lord came upon him, and he beat with that jawbone 1,000 Philistines.
En die krag van die Here het oor hom gekom, en hy het met daardie kakebeen 1,000 Filistyne verslaan.
How did he do it?
Hoe het hy dit gedoen?
That old brittle desert soaked jawbone, you'd hit it against a rock, it would fly to pieces.
Daardie ou bros woestyn deurdronke kakebeen, sou jy dit teen 'n rots slaan, sou dit in stukke spat.
And up on the helmets, it was on those Philistines which hung down and big leaves stuck up on the sides as went over the shoulders, inch thick in brass.
En op die helms wat op daardie Filistyne was, wat afgehang het en groot kra het opgestaan aan die kante waar dit oor die skouers gegaan het, duimdik en geel koper.
He stood with his jawbone and beat down 1,000.
Hy het met hierdie kakebeen gestaan en 1,000 plat geslaan.
It said the Spirit of the Lord came upon him. He was persistent.
Daar staan, die gees van die Here het oor hom gekom. Hy het volgehou.
One day a lion ran out after him and he had nothing in his hand.
Eendag het daar 'n leeu agter hom aangehardloop en hy het niks in sy hand gehad nie.
But the Spirit of the Lord came upon him, his locks still hung on his shoulder. He rent the lion with his hands.
Maar die gees van die Here het oor hom gekom. Sy lok het steeds op sy skouer gehang. Hy het die leeu met sy hande verskeur.
He was very persistent because he knew that God's promise is with him.
Hy was baie volhardend, want hy het geweet dat God se belofte met hom was.
He was able to achieve anything, for God's promise was with him to deliver.
Hy was in staat om enigiets te vermag, want God se belofte was met hom om te verlos.
John was so sure, John the Baptist, when he was born, he knew he was to be the one after he got old enough to understand about 9 years old.
Johannes was so seker, Johannes die Doper, toe hy gebore is, het hy geweet, hy sou die een wees, nadat hy oud genoeg geword het, om te verstaan, omtrent 9 jaar oud.
His father was a priest, usually they follow the line of the father.
Sy vader was 'n priester, gewoonlik volg hulle in die voetspore van die vader.
But he didn't go down to the schools and seminaries, for he knew his job was too important, he was to announce the Messiah.
Maar hy het nie daar na die skole en kweekskole gegaan nie, want hy het geweet sy taak was te belangrik. Hy moes die Messias aankondig.
We know that the angel had said so.
Ons weet dat die engel so gesê het.
He knew that he was represented in the scripture, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord.
Hy het geweet dat hy in die skrifte verteenwoordig is, die stem van een wat roep in die wildernis, berei die weg van die Here.
He knew also that Malachi 400 years before had said, behold, I send my messenger before my face.
Hy het ook geweet dat Malachi 400 jaar tevore gesê het, kyk, ek stuur my boodskapper voor my aangesig.
After being into the wilderness where he got his schooling from God, not from some theological seminary as his father was come from.
Nadat hy in die wildernis was, waar hy sy opleiding van God gekry het, nie van een of ander teologiese kweekskool soos waar het sy vader gekom het nie.
But he had an important job. He had to announce the Messiah. And he had to know what kind of a sign would be following the Messiah.
Maar hy het 'n belangrike taak gehad. Hy moes die Messias aankondig en hy moes weet watter soort van teken die Messias sou volg.
Then he noticed one day he was standing preaching to the people. He said, there's one standing among you now who you know not, whose shoes I'm not worthy to unlatch. He'll baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire.
Toe het hy opgelet een dag. Hy het gestaan vir die mense gepreek. Hy het gesê, daar staan nou een tussen julle, wie julle nie ken nie, wie se skoene ek nie werd is om los te maak nie. Hy sal julle doop met die Heilige Gees en vuur.
He was so positive of his position. He was so positive of his ministry too. He said, he's standing here somewhere now among you.
Hy was so positief oor sy posisie. Hy was so positief oor sy bediening, dat hy gesê het, hy staan nou hier ergens tussen julle.
He wasn't afraid to say it in the face of Pharisees and Sadducees and soldiers and whatever more it was.
Hy was nie bang om dit in die gesig van die Fariseërs en Sadduseërs te sê nie, en soldate en wat dit ook nog meer was.
Some of them looked for him for thousands of years, but he said he's standing among you.
Party van hulle het na hom gesoek vir duisende jare, maar hy het gesê, hy staan tussen julle.
Nobody could take it away from him. He is persistent.
Niemand kon dit van hom af wegneem nie. Hy het volgehou.
He was perseverant in the face of all.
Hy was volhardend in die aangesig van alles.
Yes, this little Greek woman no doubt had heard of him. Heard of Jesus, the great revival.
Ja, hier die Griekse vroukie het ongetwyfeld van hom gehoor. Gehoor van Jesus, die groot herlewing.
A young prophet coming up in Galilee from Nazareth. And was showing great signs and wonders.
A young prophet, wat in Galilea opgekom het, van Nazareth, en groot tekens en wonders getoon het.
She had heard of him, and faith comes by hearing.
Sy het van hom gehoor, en geloof kom deur die gehoor.
This Syrophoenician woman, being a Greek.
Hier die Syrophoenisiese vrou, was 'n Griek.
Faith finds sources that others don't see.
Geloof vind bronne, wat ander nie sien nie.
When she heard, she believed.
Toe sy gehoor het, het sy gegloof.
She might have heard of a neighbor's girl being healed of epilepsy, which the child had. And we might have heard of this epileptic being healed.
Sy kon daar gehoor het van bure se dogter, wat van epilepsie genees is, wat die kind gehad het. En hulle kon daar van hierdie epilepsie leier gehoor het, wat genees is.
So her daughter had need of healing and she had heard Jesus could do it.
So haar dogter het genesing nodig gehad en sy het gehoor, Jesus kan dit doen.
For he was God's word made flesh.
Want hy was God se woord wat vlees geword het.
St. John 1, in the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. Amen. And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us, the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Johannes 1, in die begin was die woord, en die woord was by God, en die woord was God, en die woord het vlees geword, en onder ons gewoon, dieselfde gister, vandag, en vir altyd.
He was there to reveal the promises of God for his day.
Hy was daar om die beloftes van God openbaar vir sy dag.
He's here tonight to vindicate and to reveal every promise that God made for this age. He's here to do it.
Hy is vanaand hier om elke belofte wat God vir hierdie eeu gemaak het te bevestig en te openbaar. Hy is hier om dit te doen.
He was in the days of the prophets.
Hy was in die dae van die profete.
He is in Moses, he is in David, he is in Elijah. He was in the rest of them to reveal God's promise of that age.
Hy was in Moses, hy was in David, hy was in Elia. Hy was in die res van hulle om God se belofte vir daardie eeu te openbaar.
God allotted his word to each age and he sends a prophet and the word goes to the prophet and straightens it out. And that's exactly what he's done through all ages and he's God and changes not.
God het sy woord vir elke eeu toegesê, en hy stuur 'n profeet, en die woord gaan na die profeet, en maak dit duidelik, en dis presies wat hy deur alle eeue gedoen het, en hy is God, en verander nie.
Jesus Christ is that prophet tonight, that stands among us.
Jesus Christus is vanaand daardie profeet, wat tussen ons staan.
He is the one here in the form of the Holy Ghost, who knows everything and can reveal anything that he desires to do.
Hy is die een hier in die vorm van die Heilige Gees, wie alles weet, en enigiets kan openbaar wat hy begeer om te doen.
She believed this. No matter how much people didn't believe it.
Sy het geglo. Maak nie saak hoeveel mense dit nie geglo het nie.
Faith finds a source that other people don't know anything about.
Geloof vind 'n bron waarvan ander mense niks weet nie.
When a man's got faith in God, he's got a hold of something that he can't explain it. It's something he's got a hold of.
Wanneer 'n mens geloof in God het, het hy 'n hou vas op iets dat hy dit nie kan verklaar nie. Dis iets waaraan hy 'n hou vas het.
He cannot push it or shove it or pull it. It takes him.
Hy kan dit nie stoot of dit skuif of dit trek nie. Dit verg hom.
That's the way faith is when a man really got faith in God. It finds that source that others don't see.
Dis hoe dat geloof is. Wanneer 'n mens regte geloof in God het, vind dit daardie bron wat ander nie sien nie.
His word is a sword.
Sy woord is 'n swaard.
The Bible said so.
Die Bybel het so gesê.
Won't reference that. It's Hebrews 4:12 as I got the text wrote down.
Wil julle die verwysing daarvoor hê? Dis Hebreërs 4:12 soos ek die teks neergeskryf het.
The Bible said the word of God is sharper than a two-edged sword.
Die Bybel het gesê die woord van God is skerper as 'n tweesnyende swaard.
This sword's got to be held by a hand of faith. A hand of theology won't do it.
Hierdie swaard moet vasgehou word deur 'n hand van geloof. 'N hand van teologie sal dit nie doen nie.
It's got to take a hand of faith trained in spiritual things that knows God.
Dit moet 'n hand van geloof wees, opgelei in geestelike dinge wat God ken.
Again, as I might say this, how do you believe that Jesus looked up on the audience and perceived their thoughts?
Weer eens mag, as ek dit mag sê, hoe dink julle dat Jesus na die gehoor gekyk en hulle gedagtes waargeneem het?
Because he was the word.
Omdat hy die woord was.
Let's quote the rest of the word here. Sharper than a two-edged sword, a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart.
Laat ons die res van die woord hier aanhaal. Skerper as 'n tweesnyende swaard, 'n onderskeier van die gedagtes en bedoelinge van die hart.
He was the word.
Hy was die woord.
That's the reason he could discern the thoughts that were in their heart.
Dis waarom hy die gedagtes wat in hul hart was kon onderskei.
Last night as we talked as it was in the days of Sodom, showed that man standing there eating the flesh of a calf, drinking the milk from the cow, eating butter and bread.
Gisteraand toe ons, soos dit was in die dae van Sodom, behandel het, daardie man gewys het wat daar staan, die vleis van 'n kalf eet, die melk van die koe drink, botter en brood eet.
Standing there eating with clothes on like you and I with his back turned to the tent.
Wat daar staan en eet met klere aan soos ek en jy, met sy rug gekeer na die tent.
And perceive what Sarah was thinking about in the tent. No wonder Abraham called him Elohim, the all-sufficient one. The self-existing one. Elohim.
En opgemerk het waaraan Sarah in die tent gedink het. Geen wonder Abraham het hom Elohim, die algenoegsame, die selfbestaande Elohim genoem nie.
Jesus said as it was in the days of Sodom, so shall it be at the returning of the Son of Man. It'll be the same thing.
Jesus het gesê, soos dit was in die dag van Sodom, so sal dit wees met die terugkeer van die Seun van die Mens. Dit sal dieselfde ding wees.
In the days, you notice in Sodom there said, in Luke 17:15.
In die dag het julle opgelet, daar in Sodom, daar staan in Lukas 17:15.
It said that when the days of Sodom, so shall it be in the coming of the Son of Man, when the Son of Man is being revealed.
Staan daar dat, toe die dag van Sodom, so sal dit wees met die koms van die Seun van die Mens. Wanneer die Seun van die Mens geopenbaar word.
And the days that the Son of Man is revealed like he was at Sodom, the same thing will be taking place.
En die dag dat die Seun van die Mens geopenbaar word, soos hy by Sodom was, sal dieselfde ding plaasvind.
We find out the fire is ready, the nations are ready, the evangelists have gone to their places, and every gift is set in order.
Ons vind uit die vuur is gereed, die nasies is gereed, die evangeliste het na hulle plekke toe gegaan. En elke gawe is in die orde gestel.
No wonder we should be persistent. No wonder we should be persevering.
Geen wonder ons moet volhou nie. Geen wonder ons moet volhardend wees nie.
We've got a goal to achieve for God. Let's call out the bride of Jesus Christ from all denominations, from all people, separated people for God.
Ons het 'n doelwit om te bereik vir God. Dus roep die bruid van Christus uit, alle denominasies. Uit alle mense, 'n afgesonderde volk vir God.
This Greek had heard these words. She believed it.
Hierdie Griek het hierdie woorde gehoor. Sy het dit geglo.
She had many hindrances, but her faith didn't have any.
Sy het baie struikelblokke gehad, maar haar geloof het nie enige gehad nie.
Faith knows no hindrance.
Geloof ken geen struikelblokke nie.
Her faith had no hindrance, she had, but her faith didn't have.
Haar geloof het geen struikelblok gehad nie. Sy het maar haar geloof het nie gehad nie.
You may have hindrances, but if you've got faith, it knows no defeat.
Amen.
It's positive.
Jy mag struikelblokke hê, maar as jy geloof het, weet dit nie van verloor nie. Dis positief.
Let's look at some of her hindrances just for a moment.
Laat ons na 'n paar van haar struikelblokke kyk, net vir 'n oomblik.
Someone might have said, remember, you are of a different race.
Party van hulle kon dalk gesê het, onthou, jy is van 'n ander ras.
You are a Greek, Syrophoenician by nation.
Jy is 'n Griek, Syrophoenisies van nasie.
He is a Jew.
Hy is 'n Jood.
In other words, today you'd say your denomination's not having this revival.
Met ander woorde, vandag sou jy sê jou denominasie hou nie hierdie herlewing nie.
It makes no difference your denomination whether it is or not. That woman didn't care whose denomination it was.
Dit maak geen verskil nie. Jou denominasie of dit is of nie. Daardie vrou het nie omgegee wie se denominasie dit was nie.
She was a human being who'd been created by God and she had a need and she had faith that she's going to get it.
Sy was 'n mens wat deur God geskape is en sy het 'n behoefte gehad en sy het geloof gehad en sy sou dit kry.
Whether her denomination is cooperating or not made her no difference. She started off.
Of haar denominasie saamgewerk het of nie, het aan haar geen verskil gemaak nie. Sy het 'n begin gemaak.
She might have had another critic that might have met her down the line and said, "Well, the days of miracles is past. We don't have miracles no more."
Sy het dalk 'n ander kritikus gehad wat haar eerds op die weg te gekom het en gesê het, "Wel, die dae van wonderwerke is verby. Ons het nie meer wonderwerke nie."
That could have been a Jew had she got in her over in this country where Jesus was across into Galilee.
Dat kon 'n Jood gewees het nadat sy ingekom het. Sy daar in daardie land waar Jesus was, oorkant in Galilea.
Days of miracles is past. There is no such a thing.
Daar van wonderwerke is verby. Daar is nie so iets nie.
Still she was persistent. She is persevering.
Steeds het sy volgehou. Sy het volhard.
The denominational barrier didn't stop her. Neither did any of them who believe the days of miracles is past. She knew different.
Die denominasionele grens het haar nie gestoot nie. Ook nie een van hulle wat geglo het die dag van wonderwerke is verby nie. Sy het anders geweet.
First thing, she had something inside her that told her that she'd get what she asked for.
Eerstens, sy het iets in haar gehad wat vir haar gesê het sy sou kry waarvoor sy gevra het.
Oh, people tonight, if you only can hold that in your heart, that God is here to give you the desire of your heart.
Oh, mense vanaand, as julle maar net dit in julle harte kan hou, dat God hier is om julle die begeerte van julle hart te gee.
If you meet his conditions, nothing can stand.
Amen.
As julle sy voorwaardes sal nakom, kan niks standhou nie.
There might have been a bunch of women come to her and said, "Look, Sister Lydia, what her name might have been."
Daar was dalk 'n klomp vroue wat na haar gekom het en gesê het, "Kyk, Sister Lydia," of wat haar naam ook al was.
Do you understand that your husband will leave you if you do this?
Verstaan jy dat jou man jou sal verlaat as jy dit doen?
No doubt, well, she loved her husband, but she couldn't curse or bless that which was in her.
Sonder twyfel het sy haar man liefgehad, maar sy kon nie dit wat in haar was vervloek of seën nie.
Something was telling her daughter was dying with epilepsy and she had to get to Jesus. And when she got there, something is going to take place, husband or no husband.
Iets het gesê, haar dogter is stervend aan epilepsie en sy moet by Jesus uitkom. En wanneer sy daar gekom het, gaan iets plaasvind. Man of geen man nie.
Some of them might have said, what are you going to do with this afflicted child if it fails?
Party van hulle dalk gesê, wel, wat gaan jy doen met hierdie aangetaste kind as dit misluk?
But she knew it wasn't going to fail. Something was in her that told her it can't fail.
Maar sy het geweet, dit gaan nie misluk nie. Iets was in haar wat vir haar gesê het, dit kan nie misluk nie.
If he ever was God, he still remains God. It can't fail.
As hy ooit God was, bly hy steeds God. Dit kan nie faal nie.
Therefore, she still was persevering.
Daarom was hy steeds volhardend.
Then someone might said, the circle that you belong to in the society will laugh at you.
Dan kon sommige van hulle dalk gesê het, die kring waaraan jy behoort in die samelewing sal jou uitlag.
Laugh or no laugh made her no difference.
Lag of nie lag nie, het vir haar geen verskil gemaak nie.
Something was inside of her. She was still was persevering.
Iets was binne haar. Sy was steeds volhardend.
Some of them might have said, you'll be put out of your church.
Party van hulle dan gesê, jy sal uit jou kerk gesit word.
Put out or not put out. She was on her road. Amen. Something pulling her to Jesus.
Uitgesit of nie uitgesit nie. Sy was op haar pad. Iets het haar na Jesus getrek.
There was nothing going to stand in her way. No hindrances. She was perseverant.
Daar sou niks in haar pad staan nie. Geen struikelblokke nie. Sy was volhardend.
Nothing stood in her way.
Niks het in haar pad gestaan nie.
Finally she arrived where he was.
Uiteindelik het sy aangekom waar hy was.
Many people think just because you get where he's at, it's all over. That's wrong.
Baie mense dink, net omdat jy kom waar hy is, is alles oor. Dis verkeerd.
He can come here in this building tonight and show himself alive after 2,000 years by the things that he promised to do in this day.
Hy kan hier in hierdie gebou kom vanaand en homself lewend vertoon na 2,000 jaar deur die dinge wat hy beloof het om in hierdie dae te doen.
He did last night. He does every night. He does everywhere. He proves that he's still alive.
Hy het gisteraand. Hy doen dit elke aand. Hy doen dit oral. Hy bewys dat hy steeds leef.
You can be in his presence, but that isn't it. No, sir.
En jy sou in sy teenwoordigheid kon wees, maar dit is nie dit nie. Nee, meneer.
Sometimes you meet difficult when you come into his presence. She did.
Soms ondervind jy moeilikheid wanneer jy in sy teenwoordigheid kom. Sy het.
When she arrived, then said Jesus, he was not sent to her race.
Toe sy daar aangekom het, toe sê Jesus, hy is nie gestuur na haar ras nie.
The very one that she come believing in turned her down.
Die einste een, na wie sy in die geloof gekom het, het haar weggewys.
This is a lesson.
Dit is 'n les.
The very one that she went through all these gates of sorrow and disappointment and everything to get there, but something pulsating inside of her, telling her to go, when she got there to him, he turned her down flat.
Die einste een, wat sy het deur al hierdie hekke gegaan van smart en teleurstelling en alles om daar te kom deur iets wat in haar klop haar sê om te gaan. Toe sy daar by hom kom, het hy haar bot weggeweier.
And besides that, he said her race was nothing but a bunch of dogs.
En behalwe dit, het hy gesê haar ras is niks anders as 'n klomp honde nie.
It's not meat for me to take the children's bread and feed it to you dogs.
Dis nie gepas vir my om die kinders se brood te vat en dit vir julle honde te voer nie.
What if he'd call the Pentecostals dogs?
Wat as hy die Pinkstermense honde sou noem?
No, I don't know what would have happened.
Goeiste, ek weet nie wat sou gebeur het nie.
What if he said Methodist dogs? Baptist dogs? My opinion went back and told the pastor he was right after all. There was nothing to this fellow.
Wat as hy sou sê Methodiste honde, Baptiste honde, my opinie, hy sou teruggegaan het en vir die pastoor gesê het, hy was tog maar al die tyd reg, daar is niks aan hierdie kerel nie.
But if you've got a hold and something's got a hold of you,
amen,
it's going to be different.
Yeah.
Maar as jy 'n houvas het en iets het 'n houvas op jou, gaan dit anders wees.
I'm not sent to you race of dogs. Not meet me to take the children's bread and give it to you. I'm not sent to you.
Ek nie na julle ras honde gestuur nie. Nie gepas vir my om die kinders se brood te neem en vir julle te gee nie. Ek is nie na julle gestuur nie.
Your revival is not, your company is not sponsoring this, and I'm not sent to you.
Julle herlewing is nie. Julle maatskappy borg dit nie. En ek is nie na julle gestuur nie.
And it isn't meet for me to take my time upon you when you're nothing but dogs. And why should I waste my time on you?
En dit is nie gepas vir my om my tyd aan julle te bestee wanneer julle maar net honde is nie. En waarom moet ek my tyd op julle mors?
What a disappointment that would have been to a woman that didn't have faith. That wasn't determined.
Watter teleurstelling sou dit nie wees vir 'n vrou wat nie geloof gehad het nie. Wat nie vasbeslote was nie.
Oh, if the church could only see that.
Amen.
Oh, as die kerk dit maar kon sien.
But still she held on.
Amen.
Maar sy het steeds bly vashou.
She wasn't a hothouse plant that had to be babied. One of these times you have to spray all over, you know, and keep the bugs off of it.
Sy was nie 'n kweekhuisplant wat opgepiep moes word nie. Een van die soort wat jy oral moes bespuit, julle weet, om die goggas daarvan weg te hou.
A good healthy plant, you don't have to spray it.
A goeie gesonde plant, jy hoef dit nie te bespuit nie.
A good healthy plant, a bug can't get to it. It's full of health.
A goeie gesonde plant, 'n gogga kan nie daarby kom nie. Dis vol gesondheid.
And a good born again faith in God, a real genuine Holy Ghost faith, nothing's going to turn it down.
Amen. En 'n goeie wedergebore geloof in God, 'n ware opregte Heilige Gees geloof, niks gaan dit onderkry nie.
They can't do it. It's persistent. It's going to the goal that God has promised to it.
Dit kan dit nie doen nie. Dit's volhardend. Dit gaan na die doel wat God daarvoor beloof het.
There's nothing going to turn it down. It's going anyhow.
Daar gaan niks dit onderkry nie. Dit gaan in elk geval.
Yes, she was the hybrid.
Ja, sy was nie 'n baster nie.
Today everything we got's hybrid.
Vandag alles wat ons het is gebaster.
You talk about hybrid corn. I see it out on the signs out here.
Jy praat van baster mielies. Ek sien dit op die borde hier.
It is no good. It's killing people.
Dit is nie goed nie. Dit maak mense dood.
Look at Reader's Digest said if women keep on eating, what's going to happen? They won't have their babies no more in 20 years from now. They won't be able to give birth to the children.
Kyk na Reader's Digest het gesê as vroue aanhou om dit te eet, wat gaan gebeur? Hulle sal nie meer hulle babas kry oor 20 jaar van nou af nie. Hulle sal nie in staat wees om aan hulle kinders geboorte te gee nie.
It's breaking down to cancer taking a hold.
Dit breek dit af tot kanker 'n hou vas kry.
Oh, everything, the whole thing's worm eating.
Oh, alles, die hele ding is worm gevreet.
That certainly knocks scientific on evolution out.
Dit slaan sekerlik wetenskap oor evolusie uit.
Jesus said, God said in the beginning, let every seed bring forth of its kind.
Jesus het gesê, God het gesê in die begin, laat elke saad voortbring van sy soort.
You take hybrid corn, hybrid it and plant it, plant that same seed next year, you got nothing.
Neem jy baster mielies en baster dit en plant daardie selfde saad volgende jaar, het jy niks.
You got a better looking grain, but you haven't got nothing.
Jy het 'n graan wat beter lyk, maar jy het niks.
They've hybrid everything in the world. Yes.
Hulle het alles verbaster in die wêreld.
You take a mule and or take a jack and hybrid it to a mare, you get a mule, but that mule cannot breed back itself.
Neem jy 'n mul in of neem 'n donkie hengs en baster dit met 'n merrie. Jy kry 'n mul, maar daardie mul kan homself nie voortbring nie.
He's the ignorantest thing on earth.
Hy is die onnozelste ding op aarde.
I've drove him all my life. He'll wait till the last dying minute to kick you.
Ek het hulle gedrywe my hele lewe hier. Jy sal, hy sal wag tot die allerlaaste oomblik om jou te skop.
He don't know nothing. You can't teach him nothing.
Hy weet niks nie. Jy kan hom niks leer nie.
You talk to him just like a lot of so-called Christians with their ears sticking out. They don't even pray and don't know what they're praying about.
Jy praat met hom. Hy is net 'n klomp sogenaamde Christene met die ore wat uitstaan. Ho, ho. Hulle doen nie eens balk. Hulle weet nie waaroor hulle balk nie.
Days of miracles is past. There is no such a thing. It's healing.
Daar van wonderwerke is verby. Daar is nie so iets soos genesing nie.
But you take a nice, he don't know where he come from, he don't know who papa or mama is.
Maar neem jy 'n mooi. Hy weet nie waar vandaan hy kom nie. Hy weet nie wie papa of mama is nie.
But a genuine thoroughbred horse knows who his papa was, who his mama was, who his grandpa, great-grandpa, great-great-great-great, all the way back, he knows where he come from.
Maar 'n echte, opregte geteelde perd wat weet wie sy papa was, wie sy mama was, wie sy oupa grootjie, groot, 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 die hele pad terug. Hy weet waar vandaan hy kom.
So does a genuine born-again Christian know where he come from.
So weet 'n echte wedergebore Christen waar hy vandaan kom.
His origin wasn't with John Wesley Luther or some somebody else. It began on the day of Pentecost when God himself came among his people.
Sy oorsprong was nie by John Wesley Luther of iemand anders nie. Dit begin op die Pinksterdag toe God self tussen sy mense gekom het.
And he is the word made manifest.
En hy is die woord wat gemanifesteer word.
You can tell him the word and he'll say amen.
Jy kan vir hom die woord noem en hy sal amen sê.
The other say, I don't know about that.
Die ander een sê, ek weet nie daarvan nie.
See that donkey hybrid?
Sien jy daar die donkie baster?
He don't know where he's going, he don't know where he come from. He's in an awful shape.
Sien, dit weet nie waarheen hy gaan nie. Hy weet nie waar vandaan hy kom nie. Hy is in 'n vreeslike toestand.
That woman wasn't that type.
Daardie vrou was nie daardie tipe nie.
She was no hybrid plant.
Sy was geen baster plant nie.
She got a hold of something.
Sy het iets beet gekry.
You didn't have to baby her and spray her. Say, now, darling, please, now let me beg you. You should come down.
Jy hoef haar nie te piep en haar bespoit het en te sê, nou skat asseblief, laat ek jou nou sobat, jy moet daarin kom nie.
No sir, nobody, everything trying to hinder.
Nee meneer, niemand nie, alles het haar probeer verhinder.
A real Christian fights for his position.
Een ware Christen veg vir sy posisie.
He has to stand alone, him and God, and he fights every inch of ground. So you don't have to baby him around.
Hy moet alleen staan, hy en God, en hy veg elke duim grond, sodat jy hom nie hoef op te piep nie.
That's what's the matter with the Pentecostal church today. We got Pentecostal babies. It's just been sprinkled and sprayed with this and that and the other till it's run out to a bunch of hybrids.
Dis wat die probleem vandag is met die Pinksterkerk. Ons het Pinksterbabas wat net besprinkel en bespuit is met hierdie en daardie en die ander, totdat dit 'n klomp basters uitgedraai het.
What we need today is a house cleaning from the pulpit all the way to the janitors. And I'm starting over again. Get some genuine faith born in the people. Yeah.
Wat ons vandag nodig het, is 'n hooi skoonmaak van die preekstoel, die hele pad tot die opsigter en 'n weerbegin. En om 'n bietjie opregte geloof in die mense ingebore te kry. Ja.
No, she wasn't a hybrid as a so-called crop of believers is today.
Nee, sy was nie 'n baster soos wat 'n sogenaamde oes van gelowiges vandag is nie.
What did she do? She admitted he was right.
Wat het sy gedoen? Sy het erken, hy is reg.
The word and faith always admits the word is right. Yeah. Amen. Amen.
Die woord en geloof erken altyd, die woord is reg. Amen.
If your faith don't punctuate every word of God's word with amen, there's something wrong with your experience. Amen.
As jou geloof nie elke woord van God se woord beklemtoon met 'n amen nie, is daar iets verkeerd met jou ondervinding.
The Bible said he's the same yesterday and forever. If it don't say amen to that, then there's something wrong.
Die Bybel het gesê, hy is dieselfde gister, vandag en vir altyd. As dit nie daarop amen sê nie, dan is daar iets verkeerd.
Jesus said, the works that I do, shall you do also. If it don't say amen to that, then there's something wrong.
Jesus het gesê, die werke wat ek doen, sal julle ook doen. As dit nie amen daarop sê nie, dan is daar iets verkeerd.
If it don't punctuate every word of God's promise with an amen, there's something wrong.
As dit nie elke woord van God se belofte beklemtoon met 'n amen nie, is daar iets verkeerd.
She admitted that he was right.
Sy het erken dat hy reg is.
She admitted she was nothing but a dog.
Sy het erken, sy is niks anders as 'n hond nie.
But she was after crumbs.
Maar sy was agter krummels aan.
Wouldn't be us. Oh no.
Sal nie ons wees nie. Oh nee.
We had to be set up on a seat and if they don't minister me the first night, I'll not go back the next night.
Ons moet op 'n sitplek geplaas word en as hulle my nie die eerste aand bedien nie, sal ek nie die volgende aand teruggaan nie.
Ah, see, what a difference she was.
Nou, sien, wow, hoe verskillend was sy nie.
Put back, shoved back, shoved out, put outside, whatever it was, she was determined.
Afgesit en teruggestoot, uitgestoot, een kan gesit. Wat het ook al was, sy was vasbeslote.
She was persistent, perseverant.
Sy het volgehou, volhard.
Something on the inside her told her that she was going to get it regardless of how long she had to wait. Hallelujah. What she had to go through, she would get it anyhow.
Iets in haar binneste het vir haar gesê, sy gaan dit kry, ongeag hoe lang sy moes wag, wat sy moes deurmaak, sy sou dit in elk geval kry.
Just after the crumbs, she didn't want a full course dinner.
Sy was agter die krummels aan, sy wou nie 'n volle hang maaltyd gehad het nie.
She said the dogs eat the crumbs under the master's table.
Sy het gesê, die honde eet die krummels onder die baas se tafel.
That's the way to do it.
Dis hoe om dit te doen.
Don't take the high seat, take the back seat.
Moet nie die voorste gestoeltes inneem nie. Neem die agterste gestoeltes in.
Don't do, just be the little person. The way up is down, always.
Moet nie maak, wees net die geringe persoon. Die weg na bo is ondertoe, altyd.
He that humbles himself shall be exalted, he that exalts himself shall be abased.
Hy wat homself verneder, sal verhoog word. Hy wat homself verhoog, sal verneder word.
The way up is down, always.
Die pad boontoe is ondertoe, altyd.
Remember, she had never seen a miracle.
Onthou, sy het nog nooit 'n wonderwerk gesien nie.
She was a Gentile, but she had faith.
Sy was 'n heiden, maar sy het geloof gehad.
She was something like the harlot Rahab.
Sy was ietwat soos die hoer Rahab.
She said to the spies.
Sy het vir die spioene gesê.
She didn't say, wait till I see how Joshua combs his hair. How does your generals all look? What kind of swords do they use? What instruments have they got? What kind of warfare?
Sy het gesê, wag, tot ek sien hoe Joshua se hare kam. Wat? Hoe lyk al julle generaals? Of watter soort swaarde gebruik hulle? Watter instrumente het hulle? Watter soort oorlogvoering nie?
She said, I have heard that God's with you. That's good enough for me. Amen. I want mercy.
Sy het gesê, ek het gehoor dat God met julle is. Dis genoeg vir my. Ek wil genade hê.
She believed.
Sy het geglo.
Faith cometh by hearing and hearing the word of God.
Geloof kom deur die gehoor en die gehoor van die woord van God.
Watch. For this saying, Jesus said, because she's persistent and coming.
Kyk, terwille van hierdie woord, terwille van hierdie woord, het Jesus gesê, omdat sy volgehou het en gekom het.
Now, first she called him son of David.
Nou, eers het sy hom seun van David genoem.
Now, she had, as a Gentile, had no claims on him as the son of David.
Nou, as sy het, as a heiden, geen aanspraak op hom as die seun van David gehad nie.
But when she said Lord, he was her Lord, but not son of David to it.
Maar toe sy gesê het, Here, was hy haar Here, maar nie seun van David daarvoor nie.
She had the right approach to God's gift.
Sy het die regte benadering tot God se gawe gehad.
And that's the only way to ever receive anything is come the right approach.
En dis die enigste manier om ooit enigiets te ontvang, is kom met die regte benadering.
She was the first Gentile that a miracle was ever performed on.
Sy was die eerste heiden op wie 'n wonderwerk ooit verrig is.
Faith admits the word is right, it's humble and reverent.
Geloof erken die woord is reg. Dis nederig en eerbiedig.
And the same is today, be willing to take any part anywhere just so I get there.
En dis dieselfde vandag. Wees gewillig om enige rol te speel, enige plek, net sodat ek daar kom.
Did you ever notice Martha in the presence of Jesus was persevering?
Het julle al ooit opgelet? Martha in die teenwoordigheid van Jesus was volhardend.
Martha, when she came out, though she had a brother that loved him.
Martha, toe sy ooit gekom het, hoewel sy 'n broer gehad het wat hom lief gehad het.
Though she had opened up her house and left the church and so forth, and Lazarus and he was friends.
Hoewel sy haar huis oopgemaak het en die kerk verlaat het en so voorts, en Lazarus en hy vriende was.
And Lazarus was dead in the grave and was been in there for 4 days, already deteriorating.
En Lazarus was dood in die graf en was al 4 dae daarin, alreeds bederf.
The nose had dropped in, the flesh off his bones. He was dead.
Die neus het al ingeval, die vlees van die bene af. Hy was dood.
I was talking to a woman that belongs to another faith that don't believe that he was no more than just a prophet or a good man.
Ek het gepraat met 'n vrou wat behoort aan 'n ander geloof, wat nie glo dat hy meer as net 'n profeet of 'n goeie man was nie.
I admit he was a prophet, but he was more than a prophet, he is the God of the prophets.
Yeah. Ek sal toegee, hy was 'n profeet, maar hy was meer as 'n profeet. Hy was die God van die profete.
He's all the prophets was in him plus God, and all of it together made him.
Hy was alles wat die profete was, was in hom plus God. En dit alles tesame het hom gemaak.
We was going down one night, she said, if I prove to you, Mr. Branham.
Ons het daar gegaan een aand, sy het gesê, as ek dit vir jou bewys, meneer Branham.
Said, I've just got one fault with your message.
Het gesê, ek het net een fout te vind met jou boodskap.
I said, I hope the Lord only has one fault. Fine with me.
Ek het gesê, ek hoop die Here het net een fout met my te vind.
He said, you brag too much about Jesus.
Het gesê, jy spog te veel oor Jesus.
Said you make him God.
Het gesê, jy maak hom God.
I said he was God.
Ek het gesê, hy was God.
If he wasn't God, he's the greatest deceiver the world ever had.
As hy nie God was nie, was hy die grootste bedrieger wat die wêreld ooit gehad het.
She said you make him divine.
Sy het gesê, jy maak hom goddelik.
I said he was divine.
Ek het gesê, hy was goddelik.
Or said he was a good man.
Oh, het gesê, hy was 'n goeie man.
I said he was more than a good man, he was God. He was divine.
Ek het gesê, hy was meer as 'n goeie man. Hy was God. Hy was goddelik.
I said, I'll prove to you by your own Bible he wasn't divine.
Het gesê, ek sal vir jou bewys deur jou eie Bybel. Hy was nie goddelik nie.
I said, how can you do it?
Ek het gesê, hoe kan jy dit doen?
She said in St. John the 11th chapter, when Jesus went to the grave to raise Lazarus up, the Bible said he wept.
Sy het gesê, in Johannes die 11de hoofstuk, toe Jesus na die graf gegaan het om Lazarus op te wek, het die Bybel gesê, hy het geween.
Now I said, is that your scripture?
En ek het gesê, is dit jou skrif?
I said, yes, I said, you fail.
Ek het gesê, ja, ek het gesê, jy misluk.
So how could he weep and be divine?
Het gesê, hoe kon hy ween en goddelik wees?
I said, he was both man and God.
Ek het gesê, hy was beide mens en God.
That was a man that was weeping, certainly. I'll admit that was a man weeping.
Dit was 'n mens wat geween het, sekerlik. Ek sal toegee, dit was 'n mens wat geween het.
But when he stood by the side of the grave, straightened his little frail body up and said, Lazarus, come forth. And a man been dead 4 days, stood on his feet and lived again, that was more than a man.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Maar toe hy aan die kant van die graf gestaan het, sy tenger liggaampie opgerig het en gesê het, Lazarus, kom uit. En 'n man wat dood was 4 dae, op sy voete gestaan het en weer gelewe het, was dit meer as 'n mens. Ja, meneer.
Corruption knew its master, the soul knew its creator.
Verderf het sy meester herken, die siel het sy skepper herken.
And he is 4 days journey somewhere. I don't know, neither do you.
En hy was 4 dae se reis ergens heen. Ek weet nie, julle ook nie.
But anyhow, when he spoke, he come forth.
Yes.
Amen.
Maar in elk geval, toe hy gepraat het, het hy uitgekom. Amen.
That was more than a man.
Dat was meer as 'n mens.
He was a man when he come down off the mountain that night. Had you come been hungry, come down looking up on the trees to find something to eat, looking on a tree when he cursed the tree it had no fruit.
Hy was 'n mens toe hy van die berg af gekom het, daardie aand, nadat hy gekom het, honger was, het daar gekom, kyk aan die bome om iets te kry om te eet, gekyk aan 'n boom. Toe hy die boom vervloek het wat geen vrugte gehad het nie.
He was a man when he was hungry, but when he taken 5 biscuits and 2 fish and fed 5,000, taken up 7 baskets full of fragments left, that was more than a man.
Hy was 'n mens toe hy honger was, maar toe hy 5 brode en 2 visse geneem het en 5,000 gevoed het, 7 mandjies vol oorskietstukke opgetel het, dit was meer as 'n mens. Dis dit.
He was a man when he laid out there on the water that night in the back of a ship.
Hy was 'n mens toe hy daar gelê het op die water, daardie nag agter in 'n skip.
Virtue gone out of him all day long, preaching and healing the sick. Virtue leaving from him, from the people discerning of thoughts in their heart.
Krag het van hom uitgegaan, die hele dag lank gepreek en die siekes genees. Krag wat hom verlaat het van die mense, die gedagtes in hul harte onderskei.
And 10,000 devils of the sea swore they'd drown him that night.
En 10,000 duivels van die see het gesweer, hulle sou hom daardie nag verdrink.
That little old ship like a bottle stopper out there flopping up and down, the devil said, I got him now.
Daardie ou skippie, soos 'n prop daar, het op en af gedobber. Die duivel het gesê, ek het hom nou.
And it looked like it was all over.
En dit het gelyk asof dit alles verby was.
But when he was once aroused, come up and put his foot on the rail of the boat, looked up and said, peace, be still, and the winds and the waves obeyed him. That was more than a man. That was God.
Hallelujah.
Maar toe hy eenmaal wakker geword het, opgekom het en sy voet op die rand van die boot geplaas het, en opgekyk het en gesê het, swyg, wees stil, en die winde en die golwe hom gehoorsaam het, was dit meer as 'n mens. Dit was God.
He was a man when he cried for mercy at the cross. True.
Hy was 'n mens toe hy om genade geroep het aan die kruis. Waar?
When he cried for a drink and they gave him vinegar, that was a man.
Toe hy geroep het, hy is dors, en hulle hom asyn gegee het, dit was 'n mens.
When he died bleeding, crying, crucified, nailed to a cross, he was a man.
Toe hy gesterf het, gebloei het, uitgeroep het, gekruisig is, gespyker aan 'n kruis, was hy 'n mens.
But on Easter morning, when he broke the seals of the tomb and rose again and said, I'm he that was dead and alive forevermore, that was more than a man.
Maar op die Paasoggend, toe hy die seels van die grafkelder verbreek het en weer opgestaan het en gesê het, ek is hy wat dood was en lewe tot in ewigheid, was dit meer as 'n mens.
Was God in a man, his son.
Dit was God in 'n mens, sy seun.
No wonder Martha, with this understanding, she was perseverant in the presence of Jesus.
Geen wonder nie, Martha met hierdie insig, sy was volhardend in die teenwoordigheid van Jesus.
Say, if you'd have been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, whatever you ask God, God will give it to you.
Het gesê, as u hier was, sou my broer nie gesterf het nie. Maar selfs nou, wat u ook al van God vra, God sal dit vir u gee.
Oh, if we'd only get those words in our hearts tonight.
Oh, as ons net daardie woorde vanaand in ons harte kan kry.
I know I'm sitting in a wheelchair. I know I got cancer, got heart trouble, whatever it is.
Ek weet ek sit in 'n rolstoel. Ek weet ek het kanker, het hartprobleme, wat dit ook al is.
I know the doctor says my last hour is close at hand, but even now, Lord.
Ek weet die dokter sê my laaste uur is voorhande, maar selfs nou, Here.
Whatever you ask God, he'll do it.
Wat u God ook al vra, hy sal dit doen.
And he's sitting at the right hand of his majesty to make intercession upon our confession.
En hy sit aan die regterhand van sy majesteit om in te tree na ons belydenis.
Just be as persistent as Martha was.
Wees net so volhardend soos Martha was.
Seem like he turned her down.
Het gelyk asof hy haar weggewys het.
Sent for him and he didn't go. Sent again and he didn't go.
Het hom laat roep en hy het nie gegaan nie. Het weer laat roep en hy het nie gegaan nie.
Finally, after he's buried 4 days, here he is, but she was still persistent.
Uiteindelijk, nadat hy begrawe is, 4 dae, hier is hy, maar sy het steeds volgehou.
She had a hold of something. She had seen his works and she knew that was God.
Sy het 'n hou vas op iets gehad. Sy het sy werke gesien en sy het geweet dit is God.
She knew it was. She was persistent.
Sy het geweet dit is. Sy het volgehou.
She got what she asked for.
Sy het gekry waarvoor sy gevra het.
The Shunammite woman in the presence of Elijah was persistent.
Die Shunammitiese vrou in die teenwoordigheid van Elia het volgehou.
Oh, the baby was dead and laying upon his bed.
Oh, die baba was dood en het op sy bed gelê.
And Elijah tried to take a anointed stick and stand by Gehazi to lay upon the child.
En Elia het 'n gesalfde staf probeer stuur met Gehazi om op die kind te lê.
But your faith wasn't in the stick, it was in the prophet.
Maar haar geloof was nie in die staf nie, dit was in die profeet.
She knew that God was in that prophet, for she had seen the words he said come to pass.
Sy het geweet dat God in daardie profeet is, want sy het gesien die woorde wat hy gesê het kom uit.
He was a vindicated prophet, and she knew that what he said come from God.
Hy was 'n bevestigde profeet, en sy het geweet dat wat hy gesê het van God gekom het.
And she said, as our soul lives, I'll not leave you till I find out why.
En sy het gesê, so waar as u siel lewe, ek sal u nie verlaat voordat ek uitvind waarom nie.
And she stayed with him, she was persistent until she got what she asked for.
En sy het by hom gebly. Sy het volhard totdat sy gekry het waarvoor sy gevra het.
Reminds me here not long ago a little woman coming from California when I still lived in Jeffersonville. It's been about 3 or 4 years ago.
Dit herinner my, hier nie lank gelede nie, het 'n vroukie van Kalifornië gekom toe ek nog in Jeffersonville gewoon het. Dit was omtrent 3 or 4 jaar gelede.
She had a tumor and a tumor alone weighed 50 pounds.
Sy het 'n gewas gehad en die gewas alleen het 50 pond geweeg.
They had to pack her into the building, set her back.
Hulle moes haar in die gebou indra, het haar agter gesit.
She told us to be there that night.
Hulle, sy het geweet ek sou daardie aand daar wees.
She thought I was going to pray for the sick, but I just come to speak to the audience. Maybe about what we got in here tonight.
Sy het gedink ek gaan vir die siekes bid, maar ek het net gekom om met die gehoor te praat, miskien omtrent wat ons vanaand hier binne het.
After you get through speaking, some of them told her he doesn't pray for the sick tonight.
Nadat klaar gemaak is met praat, sommige van hulle het vir haar gesê, hy bid nie vanaand vir die siekes nie.
But she wanted to be prayed for. She had said in her heart and believed she'd been in a meeting before and said, I believe if Brother Bram would pray for me, I'd be healed.
Maar sy wou voorgebid wees, het sy in haar hart gesê en het geglo. Sy was tevore in die bijeenkoms en het gesê, ek glo as Bro Branham vir my sou bid, sal ek genees word.
That night, 2 or 3 of the deacons passed her around, went out beside the house, the building, come around the back, laid her at the door.
En daardie aand het 2 of 3 diakens haar rondgedra en aan die kant van die gebou uitgegaan, agterom gekom, haar by die deur neergelê.
I started walking out with Billy Paul through the back. She grabbed me by the trouser leg. Like that.
En ek het begin uitstap met Billy Paul agterlangs. Sy het my aan die broekspyp gegryp, so.
She said, Brother Branham, she said, I've always believed if you'd ask God, God would heal me.
Sy het gesê, Bro Branham, sy het gesê, ek het nog altyd geglo, as jy God sou vra, sou God my genees.
I put my hand over on her, I said, then sister, according to your faith be it unto you.
Ek het my hand daar op haar gelê, ek het gesê, dan sister, volgens jou geloof sal dit met jou wees.
A few months after that I met her over in a meeting there. There she was standing with a perfect waistline. The 50 pound tumor was gone.
'N Paar maande daarna, ontmoet ek haar daar in 'n bijeenkomst. Daar was sy, het met 'n perfekte middellyf gestaan. Die 50 pond gewas was weg.
She said, I'll take any woman in here in the dressing room and let her see if there's a mark on me anywhere. Here's my picture, what it was.
Sy het gesê, ek sal enige vrou hier binnen in die kleedkamer inneem en haar laat sien of daar ergens op my 'n merk is. Hier is my foto, wat ek was.
What was it?
Wat was dit?
Whether you're praying for the sick or not, she was persistent.
Of jy nou vir die siekes gebid het of nie, sy het volgehou.
She'd come from California to be healed. And she wasn't going back any other way but being healed.
Sy het van Kalifornië gekom om genees te word. En sy sou nie enigszins anders teruggaan, behalwe as genees nie.
She was persistent.
Sy het volhard.
Remember being called by the bedside of a boy dying here a few years ago with black diphtheria.
Ek onthou dat ek geroep is na die bed van 'n stervende seun, hier 'n paar jaar gelede, met swart, wit seerkeel.
And they wouldn't let me go in there because I had children.
En hulle wou my nie daar laat ingaan nie, omdat ek kinders gehad het.
The doctor said, you can't go in there, you're a married man.
Die dokter het gesê, jy kan nie daar ingaan nie, jy is 'n getroude man.
I knew he was Catholic, and I said, if the boy was Catholic, would you let the priest go in?
Ek het geweet, hy is katholiek, en ek het gesê, as die seun katholiek was, sou jy die priester laat ingaan?
He said, yeah, but he's not married.
Hy het gesê, ja, maar hy is nie getroud nie.
I said, he visits children and so forth.
Ek het gesê, hy besoek kinders en so voorts.
I said, it's not the question, Mr. Branham.
Het gesê, dis nie die vraag nie, meneer Branham.
I said, you let a priest go and give him the last rites. This is the last rites. The boy's dying. Let me get to him.
Ek het gesê, jy sou 'n priester laat ingaan en om die laaste plechtigheid gee. Dit is die laaste plechtigheid. Die seun is stervend. Laat ek by hom uitkom.
Well, finally I persuade him.
Wel, uiteindelik het ek hom omgepraat.
And he dressed me up like a Ku Klux Klan or something, all kinds of things over.
En hy het my aangetrek soos 'n Ku Klux Klan of iets, allerhande goed oor.
The old mother and father were standing there.
En die ou moeder en vader het daar gestaan.
I left the meeting and the old mother and father said, if you'll come pray, my child will live.
Ek het van 'n bijeenkomst afgekom en die ou moeder en vader het gesê, as jy sal bid, sal my kind lewe.
Boy's about 17, 18 years old.
Die seun was omtrent 17, 18 jaar oud.
Had a cardiogram, a machine there, some sort.
Het 'n kardiogram daar gehad, 'n masjien van een of ander soort.
He'd been unconscious for 2 or 3 days. And he knew nothing.
Hy was al vir 2 of 3 dae bewusteloos. En hy het niks geweet nie.
The mother and father received me as I come in.
Die moeder en vader het my ontvang toe ek binne gekom het.
I knelt down and prayed a simple little prayer of faith.
Ek het neergekniel en 'n eenvoudige gebedjie van geloof gebid.
I said, sir, do you believe God?
Ek het gesê, meneer, glo jy God?
He said, with all my heart, only thing I want you to do is ask God. God will give it.
Hy het gesê, met my hele hart, al wat ek wil hê jy moet doen, is om God te vra. God sal dit gee.
I said, thank you, brother, for your confidence. May I never betray it.
Ek het gesê, dankie, broer, vir jou vertroue. Mag ek dit nooit teleerstel nie.
I laid hands up on the little fellow and prayed, Lord Jesus, let this father and mother's faith join with mine and come before your throne tonight. Let this boy live and not die because we believe in Jesus' name.
Ek het die hande op die kerkie gelê en gebid. Here Jesus, laat hierdie vader en moeder se geloof by myne aansluit. En vanaand voor u troon kom. Laat hierdie seun lewe en nie sterf nie, want ons glo in Jesus' naam.
Got up. The father reached over and grabbed the mother across the little arm along the thing he was breathing in there and said, Mother, isn't this wonderful? Isn't this wonderful? Oh, it's so wonderful.
Het opgestaan en die vader het uitgereik en die moeder beetgekry bo oor die ou eisterlongetjie van 'n ding waarin hy daar asem gehaal het en het gesê, Moeder, is dit nie wonderlik nie? Is dit nie wonderlik nie? O, dit is so wonderlik.
That little nurse standing there, she's amazed. That little cap like to fall off her head.
En daar die verpleesterkie wat daar gestaan het, sy was verstom. Daar die kappie het amper van haar kop afgeval.
She looked around and she said, Sir, I don't understand. How can you act like that, you and your wife and your son dying?
Sy het omgekyk en sy het gesê, Meneer, ek verstaan nie. Hoe kan jy so optree, jy en jou vrou en jou seun is stervend?
He said, Honey, my son's not dying.
Hy het gesê, skat, my seun is nie stervend nie.
What said doctor said that he was dying?
Wel, het gesê, dokter het gesê dat hy stervend is.
Said that ever what the machine was said when a heart ever goes that low with this fever it never has been known in history to ever come back.
Het gesê daardie wat die masjien ook al was, het gesê wanneer 'n hart eers so swak word met hierdie koors is dit nog nooit in die geskiedenis bekend dat dit ooit terugkeer nie.
I never forget that old patriarch's faith. He belonged to, I believe, the A.B. Simpson movement.
Ek sal nooit daardie ou patriarch sy geloof vergeet nie. Hy het behoort aan, meen ek, die A.B. Simpson beweging.
Walked up and put his hands up on the shoulders. He's about 60 years old. Put his hands up on the shoulders of this little girl. Looked her in the face.
Het nader gestap en sy hande gesit op die skouers. Hy was omtrent 60 jaar oud. Het sy hande op die skouers gesit van hierdie meisiekie. Haar in die oog gekyk.
She said, honey, you're looking at that machine. That's all you know to look at. But I'm looking at a promise that God said he would do it.
Hy het gesê, skat, jy kyk na daardie machine. Dis al wat ek ken. Om na te kyk. Maar ek kyk na 'n belofte dat God gesê het, hy sal dit doen.
It depends on what you're looking at.
Dit hang af van waarna jy kyk.
They were hugging one another and rejoicing their brother.
Hulle het mekaar omhels en was verheug daar, broer.
And he's married and a missionary in Africa now with two children.
En hy is getroud en nou 'n sendeling in Afrika met twee kinders.
Why? Because a father and mother could hold on from the darkest hour persistent.
Waarom? Omdat 'n vader en moeder kon bly vashou toe dit die donkerste uur was, volhardend.
Yes, sir. Persistent, have faith in God.
Ja, meneer, volhardend geloof in God hè.
Little Micah in the presence of all them 400 trained prophets were persistent when he had a vision from God.
Klein Micha in die teenwoordigheid van al daardie 400 opgeleide profete het volgehou toe hy 'n visioen van God gehad het.
Though they, he was contrary.
Hoeveel hulle, hy het verskil.
They met him and told him, now we'll put you back in the association if you just say the same thing you, they say.
Hulle het hom ontmoet en vir hom gesê, nou, ons sal jou in die vereniging terugneem as jy net dieselfde ding sal sê, jy, as wat hulle sê.
He said, as the Lord lives, I'll only say what he tells me to say.
Hy het gesê, soos die Here leef, ek sal net sê wat hy my sê om te sê.
And his vision was examined with the word of God and he pronounced this prophecy no matter what.
En sy visioen is getoets aan die woord van God en hy het sy profesie uitgespreek, ongeag.
They said, we throw him into the inner cells and give him sorrow, bread of sorrow and waters of sorrow. And when they come back, he said he'd deal with him, Ahab did.
Hulle het gesê, ons sal hom in die binneste kerkers gooi en hom verdrukking, brood van verdrukking en water van verdrukking gee. En wanneer hulle terugkom, het hy gesê, sou hy met hom handel, Ahab het.
He said, if you come back at all, God hasn't spoke to me.
Hy het gesê, as jy hoegenaamd terugkom, het God nie met my gepraat nie.
He was persistent. He knew where he was standing.
Hy was volhardend. Hy het geweet waar hy staan.
The blind man had been healed by Jesus could not argue their theology. They said, who opens your eyes?
Die blinde man, wat deur Jesus genees is, kon nie teen hulle theologie argumenteer nie. Hulle het gesê, wie het jou oog geopen?
He said, a man called Jesus of Nazareth.
Hy het gesê, 'n man genaamd Jesus van Nazareth.
He said, this man's a sinner. We know not which he come from.
Hy het gesê, hierdie man is 'n sondaar. Ons weet nie waar hy vandaan gekom het nie.
Now he gave them a good answer.
Nou, hy het hulle 'n goeie antwoord gegee.
He said, you are the religious leaders of this day. And this man has given me my sight, and yet you don't know where he come from.
Hy het gesê, julle is die godsdienstige leiers van die dag. En hierdie man het my sug gegee, en toch weet julle nie waar hy vandaan gekom het nie.
He had pretty good theology of his own.
Hy het self heel goeie theologie gehad.
He couldn't argue with them, but he knew one thing. He could see and he wasn't ashamed.
Hy kon nie met hulle redeneer nie, maar hy het een ding geweet. Hy kon sien, en hy was nie skaam nie.
His father and mother was ashamed to say something about it, but not him.
Sy vader en moeder was skaam om iets daarover te sê, maar nie hy nie.
He had seen it, he had felt it, he had the results of it.
Hy het dit gesien, hy het dit gevoel, hy het die resultate daarvan gehad.
Something had told him, and he was persistent.
Iets het hom vertel, en hy het volhard.
Philip, as soon as he seen last night's lesson, what that when come up in the presence of Jesus Christ, when he saw Simon's son, or Andrew's brother, Peter come up in the presence, which was Simon then, come in the presence of Jesus.
Philippus, sodra hy gesien het, gisteraan sy les, wat, toe hy in die teenwoordigheid van Jesus Christus gekom het, toe hy Simon, sy, of Andreas, sy broer, gesien het, Phil, Petrus het in die teenwoordigheid gekom, wat toe Simon was, het in die teenwoordigheid van Jesus gekom.
Simon had been taught as a child that Messiah would be a prophet.
Simon is geleer as 'n kind, dat die Messias 'n profeet sou wees.
When he walked into his presence and he told him, "Your name is Simon and you are the son of Jonas."
Toe hy in sy teenwoordigheid ingestap het en hy vir hom gesê het, "Jou naam is Simon en jy is die seun van Jonah."
He was persistent.
Hy het volhard.
He was ready then to become the head of the church.
Hy was toe gereed, het die hoof van die kerk geword.
When Philip saw it, he knew another good Bible reader that knew the truth.
Toe Filippus dit gesien het, het hy nog 'n goeie Bybelleser geken wat die waarheid geken het.
He was persistent.
Hy het volhard.
He went around the mountain and got him.
Hy het om die berg gegaan en hom gekry.
And when Nathanael came, a man of renown, a real Hebrew indeed, a man staunch Hebrew, real fine man, fine integrity, he was a great man.
En toe Nathanael gekom het, 'n bekende man, 'n ware Hebreër, inderdaad, 'n man, stoere Hebreër, ware goeie mens, goeie integriteit. Hy was 'n groot man.
But in the presence of his priest, in presence of every one of them, when Jesus looked upon him and said, "Behold an Israelite in whom there's no God."
Maar in die teenwoordigheid van sy priester en die teenwoordigheid van elkeen van hulle, toe Jesus na hom gekyk het en gesê het, "Aanskou, 'n Israeliet in wie daar geen bedrog is nie."
He said, "Rabbi, how did you know me? I've never seen you before. How did you know who I was?"
Het hy gesê, "Rabbi, hoe ken jy my? Ek het u nog nooit tevore gesien nie. Hoe het u geweet wie ek is?"
He said, "Before Philip called you, when you were under the tree, I saw you."
Hy het gesê, "Voor Filippus jou geroep het, toe jy onder die boom was, het ek jou gesien."
He fell at his feet and said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Thou art the King of Israel."
Hy het aan sy voete geval en gesê, "U is die Christus, die Seun van die lewende God. U is die koning van Israel."
Why, he was persistent regardless what anybody else thought.
Waarom? Hy het volhard ongeag wat enigiemand anders gedink het.
He had met the thing he had read about.
Hy het die ding ontmoet waarvan hy gelees het.
What he had expected to find in Jesus, he had found.
Wat hy verwag het om in Jesus te vind, het hy gekry.
A little prostitute woman came out the well one day to get water.
'N Klein prostituut vroutjie het daar na die put gekom op 'n dag om water te kry.
There sat Jesus, an ordinary man, dressed in ordinary clothes, eating ordinary food, talking ordinary language, just common street language like anyone else talk.
Daar sit Jesus, 'n gewone man, aangetrek in gewone klere, eet gewone kos, praat gewone taal, sommer algemene straattaal, soos wat enigiemand anders gepraat het.
And she spoke to him, he spoke to her.
En sy het met hom gepraat. Hy het met haar gepraat.
He found where her fault was. He said, "Go get your husband and come here."
Hy het gevind waar haar fout is en hy het gesê, "Gaan roep jou man en kom hierheen."
She said, "I have no husband."
Sy het gesê, "Ek het nie 'n man nie."
Said, "You said, well, we've had five and the one you're living with now is not yours."
Hy het gesê, "Jy het reg gesê. Jy het vyf gehad en die een met wie jy nou lewe is nie joune nie."
Quickly, that predestinated seed in her heart struck life.
Gou het daardie voorbestemde saad in haar hart tot lewe gekom.
When it struck the Pharisees, it just turned the whole thing black.
Toe dat die Fariseërs getref het, het dit die hele ding sommer swart laat word.
They said, "This man's Beelzebub, he's a fortune teller."
Hulle het gesê, "Hierdie man is Beelzebub. Hy is 'n fortuinverteller."
But she knew the word was sharper, more powerful than a two-edged sword and a discerner of the thoughts of the heart.
Maar sy het geweet, die woord is skerper, kragtiger as 'n tweesnede swaard en 'n onderskeier van die gedagtes van die hart.
She said, "Sir, I perceive that you are a prophet."
Sy het gesê, "Meneer, ek sien dat u 'n profeet is."
"We haven't had one for 400 years."
Ons het in 400 jaar nie een gehad nie.
"I perceive that you're a prophet."
Ek sien dat u 'n profeet is.
"But we know that when the Messiah cometh, he'll tell us these things."
Maar ons weet dat wanneer die Messias kom, sal hy vir ons hierdie dinge vertel.
He said, "I'm he that speaks to you."
Hy het gesê, "Ek is hy wat met jou praat."
"Surely the one that done the miracle would not tell a lie, he is a prophet."
Sekerlik sal die een wat die wonderwerk gedoen het, nie alleen vertel nie. Hy was 'n profeet.
She said, "I am that Messiah. I'm the one that speaks to you, me."
Sê, hy het gesê, "Ek is daardie Messias. Ek is die een wat met jou praat. Ek is hy."
Now try to stop her.
Haar nou probeer stop.
If anyone is ever in the east, you know that the man in the street would never hear a prostitute.
As iemand al ooit in die ooste was, weet jy, die man in die straat sal nooit na 'n prostituut luister nie.
She had no voice at all.
Sy het glad nie 'n stem gehad nie.
But try to stop her like a house on fire on a windy day. You couldn't do it.
Maar probeer haar stop, soos 'n huis wat brand op 'n winderige dag. Jy sou dit nie kon doen nie.
Right into the street she went screaming, come see a man who told me the things I've done. Isn't this the very Messiah?
Reg in die straat af het sy gegaan, uitgeroep, kom kyk 'n man wie vir my die dinge vertel het wat ek gedoen het. Is dit nie die enigste Messias nie?
There he sits out there at the well now. That's the very Messiah.
Daar sit hy nou, daar by die put. Dis die enigste Messias.
We've looked for that man to come and there he sits. He told me these things.
Ons het daarna uitgesien dat daar die man kom en daar sit hy. Hy het my hierdie dinge vertel.
The Bible said that the people believed because of the woman's testimony.
Die Bybel het gesê dat die mense geglo het vanweë die vrou se getuienis.
In closing I might say,
ter afsluiting kan ek sê,
I see some Spanish people sitting here might say of some as in old Mexico not long ago at the arena down there, some kind of a place.
Ek sien 'n paar Spaanse mense hier sit. Ek kan dit sê, ek was in old Mexico nie lank gelede nie, by die arena daar, een of ander soort plek.
We couldn't get in the bull ring or the big ring, but we got a place that where several thousand people had gathered.
Ons kon nie in die bul arena of die groot arena kom nie, maar ons het 'n plek daar gekry waar etlike duisende mense saamgekom het.
Brother Espinosa, I think Assembly of God, brother, you all know him. In California, he was my interpreter.
Broer Espinosa, ek dink 'n gemeente van God, broer. Julle ken hom almal van Kalifornië. Hy was my tolk.
The night before that, there'd been an old blind man come across the platform that couldn't see at all.
Die aand tevore het daar 'n ou blinde man oor die platform gekom. Wat glad nie kon sien nie.
I looked at him, I had good shoes on, good clothes.
Ek het hom gekyk. Ek het goeie skoene aangehad en goeie klere.
Poor old man, ragged trousers all tore off, his old hat sewed up with looked like binder twine and his blind white beard hanging down.
Arm ou man, verflinter, broek afgeskeur, sy ou hoed vasgewerk met het gelyk soos binderstou. En hy was blind, wit baard wat afhang.
His old big old feet, and maybe he hadn't had shoes on in years, dusty all over, totally blind.
Sy ou groot ou voete en het miskien nie skoene aangehad in jare nie, vol stof, totaal blind.
I looked at him, I thought my dad would be about that age if he'd live.
Ek het na hom gekyk. Ek het gedink my pa sou omtrent daardie ouderdom wees as hy gelewe het.
I slipped over to him, I said, how do you do, Brother Espinosa's interpreter?
Ek het oorgeklop na hom toe. Ek het gesê, aangename kennis, broer Espinosa het getolk.
I set my foot up the side of his to find out.
Ek het my voet langs syne gesit om uit te vind.
A little curtain across the platform about 4 or 5 times as wide as this.
Daar was 'n gordynkie dwars oor die platform omtrent 4 or 5 maal so wyd soos die.
I thought of my shoes fitting. I give him my shoes.
Ek het gedink as my skoene hom pas, sal ek my skoene vir hom gee.
Oh, his feet was much larger than mine.
Wow, sy voete was baie groter as myne.
I put my shoulders up against him, I could go put my arms around him. His shoulders was wider than mine. I seen that and I couldn't give him a coat.
Ek het my skouers langs hom gehou, asof ek my arms om hom wou sit. Sy skouers was breër as myne. Ek het toe gesien, ek kon hom nie my baadjie gee nie.
I thought, God, what can I do?
Ek het gedink, God, wat kan ek doen?
Poor old fella, probably hasn't had a decent meal in his life.
Arme ou kerel, het waarskynlik nie 'n ordentlike maaltyd in sy lewe gehad nie.
And there he was, eating old, rejected tortillas down there somewhere, but yet have to spend what little money he had to get a grease candle and burn it on $1 million gold altar for his sins, living in such superstition and darkness as that.
En daar was hy, het ou weggegooide tortillas daar ergens geëet, maar moes toch die bietjie geld wat hy gehad het spandeer om 'n vet kers te kry, om dit op $1 million goue altaar te brand vir sy sondes. Lewe in sulke bygeloof en duisternis soos daardie.
Oh, what a time, why can fate be so evil?
Ek het gedink, watter tyd, hoe kan die noodlot so boos wees?
I put my arm around him and cried, oh God, have mercy upon him.
Ek het my arm om hom gesit en uitgeroep, oh God, wees hom genadig.
Oh, gloria a Dios.
Hy het geskree, gloria a Dios.
About that time I looked around, he could see as good as I could. Going across the platform.
En omtrent net toe, het ek omgekyk, hy kon sien so goed as hy kon, het oor die platform beweeg.
And the next night when we come in, there was a rick of old clothes and shawls and hats up 3 or 4 feet high, like this all the way across.
En die volgende aand, toe ons inkom, was daar 'n stapel ou klere en tjalies en hoede, so 2 of 3 voet hoog, soos dit, reg oor.
How do you ever know who it belonged to?
Hoe het hulle ooit geweet aan wie dit behoort?
You think they cared?
Dink jy hulle het omgegee?
They come to church that morning at 8 or 9 o'clock. No seats to sit down in. Right out there and it poured down rain and just leaning against one another.
Hulle het daardie oggend kerk toe gekom teen 8 uur of 9 uur. Geen sitplekke om in te gaan sit nie. Sommer daar. En die reën giet neer en leen net teen mekaar.
The women with their hair all hanging down, the holding their children and things.
Die vroue met hulle hare wat sommer afhang en wat die kinders in goed vashou.
Pouring down rain, come at 9 o'clock and I wouldn't be there till about 8:30 or 9 that night.
Die reën giet neer, het teen 9 uur gekom en ek sou nie daar wees voor omtrent 8:30 of 9 daardie aand nie.
They'd be sure they're going to be there. Stood right there waiting. Come in.
Hulle wou seker maak hulle gaan daar wees. Het net daar gestaan en wag totdat ek ingekom het.
They let me down on a rope ladder on the back of the arena where I come in like this, walked out the platform.
Hulle het my aan 'n touleer laat afsak aan die agterkant van die arena waar ek sou ingekom het na die platform uitgestap het.
Billy Paul and a man that I call Manana, which means tomorrow, he is always so slow to come get me.
Billy Paul en 'n man wat ek Manana genoem het, wat môre beteken. Hy was altyd so stadig om my te kom haal.
And so I say, just come tomorrow, you done ruined tonight.
En toe het ek gesê, kom maar net môre. Jy het vanaand klaar bederf.
So you brought me over there and you let me down and come in on the platform.
Toe het hy my daarin gebring en my laat sak en ek het ingekom op die platform.
Brother Jack Moore, many of you know him, just Cross Church Report. He was with me. And Brother Espinosa and several of the brethren.
Brother Jack Moore, baie van julle ken hom. Net hier oorkant by Shreveport. Hy was by my en broer Espinosa en verskeie van die broers.
Then while we stand there on the platform, Billy come.
Toe terwyl ons daar op die platform gestaan het, het Billy gekom.
I heard a great row way out over there. There's thousands times thousands seating in there.
Ek het gehoor, daar's 'n groot saamtrek daar ver daar. Daar was duisende maal duisende sitplekke daarin.
Billy said, Daddy, you'll have to do something to the little Spanish woman over here. Said she's got a dead baby in her arms.
Billy het gesê, Papa, jy sal iets moet doen. Die Spaanse vroukie hier het gesê, sy het 'n dooie baba in haar arms.
So that baby died this morning, they say early, and Manana give out them prayer cards and said, and he ain't got a prayer card, and I ain't got one.
Het gesê, daardie baba is vanoggend dood, sê hulle vroeg, en Manana het daardie gebedskaartjies uitgegee, en het gesê, en hy het nie meer 'n gebedskaart nie. En ek het nie een nie.
Said, and she's determined to bring that baby in the prayer line.
Het gesê, en sy is vastbeslote om daar die baba in die gebedsry te bring.
Said, we've got about 400 there ready to be prayed for.
Het gesê, ons het omtrent 400 daar gereed om voor gebid te word.
I said, well, just make her stay back, because if she gets ahead, they'll start every one of them doing that.
Ek het gesê, laat haar net achterlangs bly, want as sy vorentoe kom, sal dit elkeen van hulle dit wil laat doen.
And I said, we can't do that to her. Just get in line. Maybe tomorrow we're going to be here. Tomorrow give her a prayer card.
En ek het gesê, ons kan dit nie doen nie. Sê haar om net in die ry in te laat val, miskien môre. Ons gaan nog môre hier wees om haar 'n gebedskaart te gee.
He said, you come over and try it.
Hy het gesê, kom jy soontoe en probeer dit.
Said, I got 300 ushers there that can't even hold her. And said, she won't weigh 90 pounds.
Hy het gesê, ek het 300 plekaanwysers daar, wat haar nie eens kan keer nie. En het gesê, sy sal nie eens 90 pond weeg nie.
And said, you can't horse that she runs between their legs, jumps over their shoulders or anything with this dead baby.
En het gesê, jy kan haar nie keer nie. Het gesê, sy hart op tussen jou bene deur, spring oor hulle skouers of enigiets met hierdie dooie baba.
And I said, Brother Jack, I said, she don't know me. She wouldn't know me from you. Go on down and pray for the baby and that'll settle it like that.
En ek het gesê, Brother Jack, ek het gesê, sy ken my nie. Sy sal my nie van jou onderskei nie. Gaan soontoe en bid vir die baba. En dit sal dit so afhandel.
I said, baby dead.
En ek het gesê, baba dood.
I said, yes.
Het gesê, ja.
I said, I'm speaking on faith being the substance of things hoped for.
Ek het gesê, ek het gepraat oor geloof, wat die vaste vertroue is. Die vaste vertroue van dinge waarop gehoop word.
And I was speaking, Brother Espinosa started speaking on, as I was speaking.
En ek was aan die praat, en broer Espinosa het begin voort te praat, soos wat ek gepraat het.
Brother Jack started down to pray for the baby.
Broer Jack het soontoe begin gaan om vir die baba te bid.
And as I started to look, I looked out here in front of me, and there was a little Mexican baby. No teeth, it was so little, it was smiling, looking at me. A vision.
En soos ek begin kyk het, het ek hier voor my gekyk, en daar was 'n Mexikaanse babakie, geen tande nie. Hy was so klein, hy het geglimlag. Na my gekyk, 'n visioen.
I said, wait a minute, Brother Jack. Bring the baby here.
Ek het gesê, Wag 'n oomblik, Project. Bring die baba hierheen.
And so they opened up the way.
En toe het hulle 'n pad oopgemaak.
Here come the little woman with the prayer beads in her hands and falling on the floor, Holland Padre.
Hier kom die vroukie met die bidsnoer in haar hande en val op die vloer, roep uit Padre.
And I raised her up. I said, "Don't."
En ek het haar opgerig. Ek het gesê, "Moenie."
She had a little blue and white striped blanket, a little stiff baby about that long laying her arms.
Sy het 'n blou en wit gestreepte kombersie gehad, 'n klein, stywe baba, omtrent so lank, het in haar arms gelê.
I said, "Ask her when it died."
Ek het gesê, "Vra haar wanneer dit dood is."
Said it died in the doctor's office that morning, about 9 o'clock.
Het gesê, dat het in die dokter se kantoor gesterf, daardie oggend, omtrent 9:00.
This is about 9:30, 10 o'clock that night.
En dit was omtrent 9:30 of 10:00 daardie aand.
And it was soaking wet, she'd been standing her hair all down.
En sommer sopnat, sy het gestaan. Haar hare het afgehang.
Pretty little woman. And she probably her first baby, she looked to be 25 years old or something.
Mooi vroukie, en sy, waarskynlik, haar eerste baba. Sy het so 25 jaar oud gelyk, of so iets.
And I said, Brother Espinosa, don't interpret this prayer, because I just seen a vision, a little dead baby, or a little baby out there laughing at me. I said, it might be the baby.
En ek het gesê, broer Espinosa, moenie hierdie gebed tolk nie, want ek het pas 'n visioen gesien van 'n klein dooie ba of 'n babatjie daar wat vir my lag. Ek het gesê, dit is dalk die baba.
And I put my hands upon the little blanket and I said, "Dear Heavenly Father, I don't know what the vision meant, but I seen the little baby."
En ek het my hand op die kombersie geplaas en ek het gesê, "Liewe Hemelse Vader, ek weet nie wat die visioen beteken het nie, maar ek het die babatjie gesien."
If that baby, you're ready to call it back to life, I call for its life in the name of Jesus Christ.
As daar die baba, u gereed is om hom na die lewe terug te roep, sal ek om sy lewe roep in die naam van Jesus Christus.
Let out a yell, he kicked that blanket and began screaming like that.
Hy het 'n skree gegee en daar die kombers geskop en so begin skree.
The businessman's voice packed it long ago.
En ek, die sakemanne, so voice het dit geplaas nie lank gelede nie.
I said, Brother Espinosa, don't say nothing about that now.
Ek het gesê, broer Espinosa, moenie nou iets daarvoor sê nie.
You send a runner after that baby and that woman and get it to the doctor and get a signed affidavit before you publish that now. I said, because it must be true. We don't know.
Stuur jy 'n hardloper agter daardie baba en daardie vrou aan en kry hom by die dokter en kry 'n ondertekende verklaring voor jy dit nou publiseer. Het ek gesê, want dit moet waar wees, ons weet nie.
So he sent a runner.
So toe het hulle 'n hardloper gestuur.
The doctor signed an affidavit that baby died with double pneumonia that morning at 9 o'clock in his office.
En die dokter het 'n verklaring onderteken. Die baba het gesterf aan dubbele longontsteking daardie oggend in sy om 9:00 in sy kantoor.
And had no respiration, his heart was gone, been dead and stiff.
Dit het geen asemhaling gehad nie. Sy hart het gaan staan, was dood en styf.
And there that little woman was, wow, because she was persistent.
Amen.
En daar was daar die vroutjie. Waarom? Omdat sy volgehou het.
Nothing's going to stop her. She was persistent.
Niks sou haar keer nie. Sy het volgehou.
She was persevering. Though her priest would have put her out of the church, certainly he would. No matter what happened.
Sy het volhard. Al sou haar priester haar uit die kerk sit, hy sou sekerlik. Maak nie saak wat gebeur het nie.
She'd have been looking at the fence a few nights before as she'd seen that old blind man receive his sight.
Sy het toevallig by die draad gekyk 'n paar aande tevore en sy het daardie ou blinde man sy sig gesien ontvang.
If God could give sight to the blind, he could raise the dead. Yeah.
As God sig aan die blinde kon gee, sou hy die dooie kon opwek.
And she had a need.
En sy het 'n behoefte gehad.
She was persistent. Like this Serbian woman, she got her desire because she was persistent.
Sy het volgehou, soos die Syro-Fenisiese vrou. Sy het haar begeerte gekry, omdat sy volgehou het.
Brother and sister, we're in the presence of Jesus Christ.
Broer en suster, ons is in die teenwoordigheid van Jesus Christus.
He said, wherever two or three are assembled in my name, there I am in the midst of them.
Hy het gesê, waar twee of drie in my naam vergader, daar is ek in hulle midde.
Whatever they agree upon is touching one thing and ask, they shall receive.
Waaroor hulle ook al saamstem, so ver dit een ding raak en vra, sal hulle ontvang.
Let us be persistent now in the presence of God as we bow our heads.
Laat ons nou volhardend wees in die teenwoordigheid van God, soos ons hoofde buig.
Our gracious heavenly Father, We've been speaking for about 30 something minutes now or more for thy kingdom.
Ons genadigde hemelse Vader, ons het nou vir omtrent 30 minute of meer gepraat vir u koninkryk.
God made the promise. God is obligated to his promise.
God het die belofte gemaak. God is verplig tot sy belofte.
Let us, Lord, remember and be like that little woman, persistent.
Laat ons, Here, onthou en soos daardie vroutjie wees, volhardend.
If Jesus is here in our midst, then let us hold on to him until we have achieved that what we've come for.
As Jesus hier in ons midde is, laat ons dan aan hom vashou totdat ons bereik het dit waarvoor ons gekom het.
If there are those here tonight who are not saved, may they hold on until the saving grace of God has received them.
As daar diegene vanaand hier is wat nie gered is nie, mag hulle vashou totdat die reddende genade van God hulle ontvang het.
If they are here without the baptism of the Holy Spirit, may they be like that little woman. Let not time or anything else stand in the way.
As hulle hier is sonder die doop van die Heilige Gees, mag hulle wees soos daardie vroukie, nie tyd of iets anders in die weg laat staan nie.
They'll hold and be perseverant until the Holy Spirit fills their life with the grace of God.
Hulle sal vashou en volhardend wees totdat die Heilige Gees hulle lewe met die genade van God vervul.
If they're sick, may they not let loose.
As hulle siek is, mag hulle nie laat los nie.
May they hold like Jacob. How perseverant he was.
Mag hulle vashou soos Jakob. Hoe volhardend was hy nie.
He held on and said, I'll not let you go until you bless me.
Hy het vashou en gesê, ek sal u nie laat gaan voor u my seën nie.
That blessing meant life to him. And so does it mean to us tonight.
Daardie seën het die lewe vir hom beteken. En so beteken dit vir ons vanaand.
And healing means life to us, Lord.
En genesing beteken lewe vir ons, Here.
We pray that your presence will come, that we'll be able to get a hold of you, and you get a hold of us like you did with Jacob, that wrestling prince.
Ons bid dat u teenwoordigheid sal kom, dat ons in staat sal wees om 'n houvas op u te kry en u 'n houvas op ons sal kry, soos u met Jakob gemaak het, daardie worstelende prins.
That you'll change our name from the church book here on earth to the Lamb's book of life in heaven.
Dat u ons naam sal verander van 'n kerkboek hier op aarde na die Lam se boek van die lewe in die hemel.
Persevering, holding on until God confirms his promise in us.
Volhardend, vashou totdat God sy belofte in ons bevestig.
We ask it in his name.
Ons vra dit in sy naam.
Lord, we know a word from you will mean more than a millions that anyone else could speak.
Here, ons weet 'n woord van u sal meer beteken as 'n miljoene wat enigiemand anders kon praat.
Come, Lord, and vindicate this that I've told the truth.
Kom, Here, en bevestig dit dat ek die waarheid gepraat het.
You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. You are the word.
U is dieselfde gister, vandag en vir altyd. U is die woord.
You was the word that was in Noah.
U was die woord wat in Noag was.
You're the word that was in Moses.
U is die woord wat in Moses was.
You was the word that was in Elijah.
U was die woord wat in Elia was.
You was the word that was in David.
U was die woord wat in David was.
You are the word made flesh and is among us tonight.
U is die woord wat vlees geword het en tussen ons is vanaand.
You're here to vindicate every promise that you made for this hour, as it was in the days of Sodom. All these promises that you made, you're here to confirm it.
U is hier om elke belofte wat u vir hierdie uur gemaak het te bevestig, soos dit was in die dae van Sodom. Al hierdie beloftes wat u gemaak het, u is hier om dit te bevestig.
Grant it tonight, Father. We'll watch to see you here.
Skenk dit vanaand, Vader. Ons sal kyk om u hier te sien.
And then may the church reach up by faith and take a hold and say, I'm perseverant, Lord.
En dan mag die kerk na bo reik in die geloof en 'n houvas kry en sê, ek is volhardend, Here.
I'll stay here like the unjust judge that the widow had a hold of.
Ek sal hier bly soos die onregverdige regter op wie die weduwee 'n houvas gehad het.
And if that unjust judge to get rid of the woman gave her her desire, how much more will the heavenly Father give those that he's expecting to hold to him tonight.
En as daardie onregverdige regter om van die vrou ontslae te raak, haar begeerte vir haar gegee het, hoeveel te meer sal die hemelse Vader gee vir diegene wat hy verwag om aan hom vas te hou vanaand.
Grant it in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Skenk dit in Jesus se naam bid ons. Amen.
The Lord be blessed.
Geseend sê die Here.
I want to see the you give back.
Ek wil sien Billy, het jy kaartjies uitgegee?
200. What's the ones you give out today? H.
Watter is dit wat jy vandag uitgegee het? H.
Where did we start from one last night, didn't we?
Waar vandaan het ons begin een gisteraand, het ons nie?
Let's start from somewhere else tonight.
Laat ons ergens anders begin vanaand.
The prayer card tonight is H.
Die gebedskaart vanaand is H.
Every last prayer card, hold on to them. See, we're going to pray for everyone. Just hold on. Hold that prayer card.
Wie ook al gebedskaarte het, hou hulle vas, sien. Ons gaan vir elkeen bid. Hou net vas. Hou vas aan daardie gebedskaart.
You give a man a prayer card, he's 60% healed right then, see.
Gee jy 'n mens 'n gebedskaart, is hy 60% genees net daar, sien?
He knows he's going to get in line, so just he just hold it.
Hy weet hy gaan in die ry kom, so dus hy moet dit net hou.
That's why we give him out.
Dis waarom ons hulle uitgee.
Let's start from, let's make it from 80 tonight. Start from 80, 90, 100.
Laat ons begin by, laat ons sien by, laat ons dit van 80 afmaak vanaand. Begin by 80, 90, 100.
Who has prayer card H? H like heaven, H 80, raise up your hand.
Wie het gebedskaart H, H soos hemel, H 80, steek op jou hand.
See if, maybe I'm wrong, maybe we start from somewhere else.
Kyk of ek, miskien is ek verkeerd, ons sal dan maar van ergens anders begin.
Sir, I didn't see it.
Meneer, ek het dit nie gesê nie.
Oh, back, all right, come here sir.
O, hier achter, goed, kom hier na toe meneer.
H 80, H 81, who has 81, raise up your hand.
H, 80, H, 81, wie het 81, sal jy jou hand opsteek.
81, over here, come lady.
81 hier, oorkant, kom dame.
82, who has 82, would you raise up your hand, right there, 82.
82, wie het 82, sal jy jou hand opsteek, net daar, 82.
All right, 82, who has prayer card, H 82.
Goed, 82. Wie het gebedskaart H82?
There's 80, 81. We want H82.
Daar is 80, 81. Ons wil H82 hê.
How would you say it in Spanish? Might be somebody in Spanish. All right, 82.
Hoe sal jy dit in Spaans sê? Is dalk iemand in Spaans? Goed, goed, 82.
83. H83. Who has prayer card H83?
83, H, 83, wie het gebedskaart H83?
Look on your prayer card.
Kyk op jou gebedskaart.
Look at your neighbor's prayer card, maybe they're deaf and can't hear.
Kyk na jou buurman se gebedskaart, miskien is hulle doof en kan nie hoor nie.
H83.
H83, 83.
Don't get them cards if you're not going to use them, see?
Moet nie daardie kaarte neem as jy hulle nie gaan gebruik nie, sien?
Get them, use them, see?
Kry hulle, gebruik hulle, sien?
Don't pass them to someone else, keep them yourself.
Moet hulle nie vir iemand anders gee nie, hou hulle self.
Be turned down in the prayer line, see?
Jy sal weggewees word in die gebedsry, sien?
So take your card, come listen to the instructions before the meeting, take your prayer card and then stay in your seat, see?
So neem jou kaartjie, kom, luister na die instructies voor die bijeenkomst. Neem jou gebedskaart en bly dan in jou sitplek, sien?
H83, where's it at?
H83, waar is dit?
84.
84.
The lady here, 85. 86.
Die dame hier, 85. 86.
That's right, respond quick.
Dis reg, reageer gauw.
86, 87, 88, 89.
86, 87, 88, 89.
90. 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100.
90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100.
Brother Grant, if you want to sit, they all get in the prayer line.
Tell hulle, Brook Grant, as hy sal, en kyk of hulle allemaal in die gebedsry kom.
Now, I'm going to ask everybody in here now. We'll be done in about 10-15 minutes.
Nou, ek gaan almal hier binne nou vra. Ons sal oor omtrent 10-15 minute klaar wees.
I'm going to ask everybody in here to remain in your seat that wasn't called. Be real reverent. Quiet.
Ek gaan almal hier binne vra om in julle sitplekke te bly. Wat nie geroep is nie. Wees heel eerbiedig, stil.
Be persistent now.
Wees nou volhardend.
Let's give you another little story.
Laat ons julle nog 'n storieetjie gee.
One time there was a woman.
Eenmaal was daar 'n vrou.
Jesus said his fame had spread abroad over in Gadarea. And a little woman came down, or not in Gadarea, it was another country.
Jesus het sy roem het versprei oor see in Gadara. En 'n vroukie het hierheen gekom of nie in Gadara nie. Dit was 'n ander streek.
And she had heard of him. She had a blood issue.
En sy het van hom gehoor. Sy het bloedvloeiing gehad.
She came to the meeting where Jesus was at the seashore, but she couldn't get to him.
Sy het gekom na die bijeenkoms waarby Jesus was by die seekus, maar sy kon nie by hom uitkom nie.
And so she said within her heart, now listen, within her heart, that if I can touch his garment, I'll be made well.
En toe sê sy in haar hart, luister nou, in haar hart, dat as ek sy kleed kan aanraak, sal ek gesond word.
Remember the story?
Onthou julle die story?
Now she slipped through and touched his garment.
Nou, sy het deurgeglip en sy kleed aangeraak.
Now, what happened?
Nou, wat het gebeur?
Jesus turned and said, who touched me?
Jesus het omgedraai en gesê, wie het my aangeraak?
Why, Peter rebuked him.
Wel, Petrus het hom bestraf.
Just think of that now while they're seeing if they're all there.
Dink nou net daaraan, terwyl hulle kyk of hulle almal daar is.
Peter rebuked him and said, Lord, something like this. Why, people wonder if you're in your right mind.
Petrus het hom bestraf. Hy het gesê, Here, iets soos dit. Wel, mense sal wonder of u by u verstand is.
Why, everybody, hello rabbi, hello prophet. This is the young prophet of Nazareth. This is the Galilean prophet. Hello there.
Wel, almal, hello rabbi, hello profeet. Is dit die jong profeet van Nazareth? Is dit die Galileese profeet? Hello daar.
Away with such a man, said the priest and all. Get away from everybody.
Weg met so 'n man, het die priesters en hulle almal gesê. Gee pad van hom af, almal.
But he held on just the same. She did.
Maar hy het vasgehou, nie teenstaande, sy het.
She said, if I can only touch his garment. She did.
Sy het gesê, as ek net sy kleed kan aanraak, sy het.
Then Peter said, well, you make people think you're out of your mind.
Toe het Petrus gesê, wel, u laat mense dink u is van u verstand af.
He said, but I perceive that I've gotten weak.
Hy het gesê, maar ek merk dat ek swak geword het.
How many knows that?
Hoeveel weet dit?
Virtue, which means strength, has gone from him.
Deug, wat krag beteken, het van hom uitgegaan.
And he looked around over the audience until he found the woman.
En hy het rondgekyk oor die gehoor totdat hy die vrou gekry het.
And when he found the little lady, what did he say to her? He said, thy faith has saved thee.
En toe hy die dametjie gekry het, wat het hy vir haar gesê? Hy het gesê, jou geloof het jou gered.
Told her of her blood issue and she been saved.
Het haar van haar bloedvloeiing vertel dat sy gered is.
Is that right?
Is dit reg?
Now how many believes that he's the same yesterday, today and forever? Raise up your hand.
Nou hoeveel glo dat hy gister, vandag en vir altyd dieselfde is? Steek jou hand op.
How many knows that this is the truth?
Hoeveel weet dat dit die waarheid is?
But Hebrews 3 says that right now he is a high priest that can be touched by the feeling of our infirmities.
In Hebreërs 3 staan daar, op hierdie oomblik is hy 'n hoëpriester wat deur ons swakhede geraak kan word.
How many knows that?
Hoeveel weet dit?
Well, if he's the same yesterday, today and forever, only he's not in physical form.
Wel, as hy gister, vandag en vir altyd dieselfde is, net hy is nie in fisiese vorm nie.
When he returns like that, time is over. He'll take the church with him.
Wanneer hy so terugkeer, is die tyd verby. Sal hy die kerk met hom neem.
But he's sharing the form of the Holy Ghost to come into me and into you and perform his same works.
Maar hy is hier in die vorm van die Heilige Gees om in my en in jou in te kom en sy selfde werke te doen.
It said in John 14:12, he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also.
Hy het gesê in Johannes 14:12, hy wat in my glo, die werke wat ek doen, sal hy ook doen.
Is that right?
Is dit reg?
And if the word is in us and we're telling the truth and it is the word that he promised for today, then isn't the word of God sharper than a two-edged sword and a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart?
En as die woord in ons is en ons die waarheid praat en dit is die woord wat hy vir vandag beloof het, is die woord van God dan nie skerper as 'n tweesnede swaard en 'n onderskeier van die gedagtes en voornemens van die hart nie?
Does the Bible say that?
Sê die Bybel dit?
Was not all the prophets could discern the thoughts in the people's mind?
Was al die profete nie in staat om die gedagtes in in die mense se gemoed te onderskei nie.
Is that right?
Is dit reg?
Why? It was the word that was in them. God's word for that day. See?
Waarom? Dit was die woord wat in hulle was, God se woord vir daardie dag, sien?
That's how they were vindicated. That was their credentials.
Dis hoe hulle bevestig is. Dit was hulle getuigskrifte.
None of them belonged to an organization, not one. Never did.
Nie een van hulle het aan 'n organisasie behoort nie. Nie een nie. Het nooit nie.
Their credentials was their ministry.
Hulle getuigskrifte was hul bediening.
God said, if there be one among you spiritual prophet, and what he says comes to pass, then hear him. For I'm with him.
God het gesê, as daar een onder julle is wat geestelik is of 'n profeet, en wat hy sê kom uit, luister dan na hom, want ek is met hom.
But if it don't come to pass, well, don't hear him.
Maar as dit nie uitkom nie, wel, moenie na hom luister nie.
It must not just be once, it must continually, all the time, from prophets.
En dit moet nie net een keer wees nie, dit moet aanhouden die hele tyd vir profete.
There's a gift of prophecies in the church which is to be examined by the examiners before it can be told to the church, of course.
Daar is 'n gawe van profesie wat in die kerk is, wat ondersoek moet word deur die ondersoekers voordat aan die kerk oorgedra kan word, natuurlik.
Let it be before two or three judges and then told her.
Laat dit voor 2 of 3 beoordelaars wees en dan word dit vir haar vertel.
But a prophet is born a prophet. Predestinated, foreordained.
Maar 'n profeet word 'n profeet gebore, voorbestem. Verordeneer.
Jeremiah, God said, before you even formed in your mother's wombs, I ordained you a prophet over the nation.
Jeremiah het God gesê, voor jy selfs in jou moeder se skoot gevorm is, het ek jou as 'n profeet oor die nasie bestem.
John the Baptist, 712 years before he was born, he is the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. See? Sure.
Johannes die Doper, 712 jaar voor hy gebore is, hy is die stem van een wat roep in die wildernis, berei die weg van die Here. Sien, sekerlik.
Notice. Now when Jesus is here on earth, he made the sacrifice for healing and for salvation.
Let nou op, toe Jesus hier op aarde was, het hy die offer gebring vir genesing en vir verlossing.
Do we believe that?
Glo ons dit?
Jesus could not come tonight and save you. He's already done it.
Jesus sou nie vanaand kon kom en jou red nie. Hy het dit al reeds gedoen.
The sin question was settled.
Die sonde vraagstuk is besleg.
He's the Lamb of God that took away the sins of the world.
Hy is die lam van God wat die sondes van die wêreld weggeneem het.
He was wounded for our transgressions. With his stripes we were healed.
Hy is vir ons oortredinge deurboor. Deur sy wonde het daar vir ons genesing gekom.
It's a past tense.
Dis 'n verlede tyd.
No matter how much you scream out, how much you scream out, that wouldn't do a bit of good until you accept it.
Maak nie saak hoeveel jy sal uitroep en hoeveel jy sal uitroep nie. Dit staan jy 'n greintjie jap totdat jy dit aanvaar nie.
And he's a high priest sitting at the right hand of the majesty on high to make intercessions on our profession.
En hy is die hoëpriester wat sit aan die regterhand van die majesteit omhoog om voorspraak te maak op ons belydenis.
You got to accept it and profess it.
Jy moet dit aanvaar en dit bely.
Correct. Same way by healing.
Sin, dis korrek, dieselfde manier met genesing.
But what if he was standing here tonight? Wearing this suit that he gave me, what would he do in the prayer line?
Maar wat daarvan as hy vanaand hier gestaan het, hierdie pak klere gedra het wat hy vir my gegee het? Wat sou hy in die gebedsry gedoen het?
How would you know it was Jesus? See?
Hoe sou jy weet dit is Jesus? Sien?
Now, as far as somebody comes say, oh, Jesus, will you heal me? It's I've already done it.
Nou, in sover as iemand sou kom en sê Jesus, sal hy my genees? Hy sou sê ek het dit reeds gedoen.
Now if he had nail scars in the hand, anybody could have that. Any scar could be.
Nou as hy spykermerke in hul hande gehad het, en enige een sou dit kon hê, sien, enige merk kon wees.
But what it is? How do you know the? What do you know the, what kind of bind it is?
Maar wat is dit? Hoe weet jy? Wat weet jy watter soort wingerdstok dit is?
It's what kind of life it's got in it.
Dis watter soort lewe dit daarin het.
And every bind, if the first branch to come out of that bind, Jesus Christ, they wrote a book of Acts behind it.
En elke wingerdstok, as die eerste loot wat uit daardie wingerdstok Jesus Christus gekom het, hulle het 'n boek van Handelinge daarna geskryf.
Is that right?
Is dit reg?
If it ever puts forth another one, they'll write another book of Acts.
As dit ooit 'n ander een voortbring, sal hulle nog 'n boek van Handelinge skryf.
For if it bore grapes the first one, the next time it can't have lemons.
Want as dit druiwe gedraai het, die eerste een, kan dit nie die volgende keer suurlemoene hê nie.
But a lemon vine can live in that, it's a citrus fruit.
Maar 'n suurlemoenloot kan daarin lewe. Dis 'n sitrusvrug.
But it's living of its own, it'll always bring forth lemons. It's a grafted vine into it.
Maar dit lewe op sy eie. Dit sal altyd suurlemoene voortbring. Dis die geënte loot daarin.
But the vine itself puts forth a branch, it'll bear fruit like the person did. Or it'll be the life that's in Jesus Christ will be in that vine. That's right.
Maar as die wingerdstok self 'n loot voortbring, sal dit vrugte dra soos die eerste een het. Want dit sal die lewe wees wat in Jesus Christus is. Sal in daardie loot wees. Dis reg.
Jesus said, he that believeth in me, the works that I do shall he also.
Jesus het gesê, hy wat in my glo, die werke wat ek doen, sal hy ook.
Now, if he was sure, he would be known by his life and by the things that he promised for this age.
Nou, as hy hier was, sou hy aan sy lewe geken wees en aan die dinge wat hy vir hierdie eeu beloof het.
How many were sure last night? Let's see your hand.
Hoeveel was gisteraand hier? Laat ons jou hand sien. Almal van julle, veronderstel ek.
All right. Now there's people, everyone in that line, as far as I know, is a total stranger to me.
Goed, nou daar is mense. Elkeen in daardie ry, so ver as wat ek weet, is 'n totale vreemdeling vir my.
If that's right, raise up your hands, each one. Is it, are you a stranger?
As dit reg is, steek jou hand op. Elkeen is jy 'n vreemdeling?
How many out there are strangers to me?
Hoeveel daar buite is vreemdelinge vir my?
All right, only thing I ask you to do is have faith and believe that I've told you the truth.
Goed, al wat ek jou vra om te doen, is om geloof te hê en te glo dat ek jou die waarheid vertel het.
Now look, Christ promised these things for the last days.
Nou kyk, Christus het hierdie dinge vir die laaste dae beloof.
Now I know you've had great warriors here in the city, perhaps Oral Roberts and all like the late Jack Cole and those great men of faith. They live their time.
Nou, ek weet julle het groot stryders hier in die stad gehad. Miskien Oral Roberts en soos oorlede Jack Cole en daardie groot manne van die geloof. Hulle het in hul tyd gelewe.
But remember, the last sign that the Gentile world seen before the promised son arrived in Abraham's time, which is the father of all, and Jesus promised the same thing.
Maar onthou die laaste teken wat die heidense wêreld gesien het voor die beloofde seun in Abraham se tyd gekom het, wat die vader van almal is, en Jesus het dieselfde ding beloof.
The last sign that was showed to the church elected. Now remember, there was one, two went down and preached in the Sodom. They never showed this sign. Neither is it today.
Die laaste teken wat vir die uitverkore kerk getoon is. Onthou nou, daar was een. Twee het heen gegaan en in die Sodom gepreek. Hulle het nooit hierdie teken getoon nie. Ook word dit nie vandag nie.
But to the called out church, the sign was shown and so did Jesus prophesy to be the same thing.
Maar aan die geroepe kerk is die teken getoon. En so het Jesus geprofeteer. Dit sal dieselfde ding wees. Sien?
God manifested in flesh. Discerning the thoughts that's in the heart.
God gemanifesteer in vlees. Sien? Wat die gedagtes wat in die hart is onderskei. Sien?
Now he promised that. Both heavens and earth will fail, but that won't.
Nou, hy het dit beloof. Beide hemele en aarde sal val, maar dit sal nie.
Now, if he will manifest that to show that he's here present, how many of you will believe him for your healing and whatever you have need of?
Nou, as hy dit sal manifesteer, om te toon dat hy hier teenwoordig is, hoeveel van julle sal glo vir julle genesing en waaraan julle ook al behoefte het?
Our Lord Jesus, now it's to you, Father. Whatever your will is, let it be done. I'm your servant.
Nou, Here Jesus, nou is dit by u, Vader. Wat ook al u wil is, laat dit geskied. Ek is u diensknegt.
These are all your servants, or many of them in here.
Hulle is almal u diensknegte, of baie van hulle hier binne.
Let those who are not your servants, by your presence, knowing that maybe before morning you'll have to look upon your face.
Laat hulle, wat nie u diensknegte is nie, deur die teenwoordigheid, in die wete dat hulle dalk voor môre in die aangesig sal moet kyk.
Now you can smile upon them with grace, but then you'll be their judge.
Nou kan u vir hulle glimlag met genade, maar dan sal u hulle regter wees.
Let it come to pass, Lord, that Jesus will come among us tonight and perform and do like he did before his crucifixion.
Laat het gebeur, Here, dat Jesus tussen ons sal kom vanaand en optree en maak soos hy gedoen het voor sy kruisiging.
Will be assured to us in the face of all heathen religions that our Savior is not dead but has risen from the dead.
Sal versekering vir ons wees in die aangesig van alle heidense godsdienste dat ons verlosser nie dood is nie, maar uit die dood opgestaan het.
And after 2000 years he's just as alive tonight as he was then.
En na 2000 jaar is hy net so lewend vanaand as wat hy toe was.
And may we like those from Emmaus say, did not our hearts burn within us as he talked to us along the road?
En mag ons, soos hulle van Emmaus sê, het ons harte nie in ons gebrand toe hy met ons gepraat het langs die pad nie.
Let thy presence be known.
Laat die teenwoordigheid bekend wees.
May we see you tonight in the power of your resurrection.
Mag ons u sien vanaand in die krag van die opstanding.
And may the people believe then, Lord, because of your great august presence.
En dan mag die mense dan glo, Here, vanweë u groot verhewe teenwoordigheid.
We ask in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Ons vra in Jesus Christus se naam. Amen.
Now I take every spirit, each one of you are spirit.
Nou, ek neem elke gees. Elkeen van julle is 'n gees.
Remember, you've never seen me. You see this old wore out hull here that declares this voice.
Onthou, julle het my nog nooit gesien nie. Julle sien hierdie ou verslete dop hier wat hierdie stem verklaar.
Now this voice either is coming from God or it's not. Same as yours.
Nou, hierdie stem kom of van God of nie. Net soos julle sin.
This voice is just packed around this hull, which I'll swap it someday for a new one that won't get old.
Hierdie stem word maar net in hierdie dop rondgedra, wat ek dit eendag sal verruil vir 'n nuwe een wat nie oud sal word nie.
But friend, each one a spirit.
Maar vriend, elkeen 'n gees.
So when you move, see, when you have control there, see, it interrupts to set real still, be in prayer.
So wanneer jy beweeg sien, wanneer jy daar beheer het sien, onderbreek dit. Sit net regtig stil, wees in gebed.
I want you, if God does something, would you be thankful to me? Certainly. Praise him, then be reverent, watch.
Ek wil hê julle, as God iets doen, moet ons dankbaar teenoor hom wees. Sekerlik, prys hom. Wees dan eerbiedig en kyk.
Just sit real still and believe with all your heart.
Sit net regtig stil en glo met julle hele hart.
Now you out there that has no prayer cards, no matter where you are, you just believe and say this, Lord Jesus, what he told us, it's in the Bible.
Nou julle daar buite wat geen gebedskaarte het nie, maak nie saak waar julle is nie. Glo julle maar net en sê dit, Here Jesus, wat hy vir ons gesê het, dis in die Bybel.
I know that you promised that. And I know it has to be you.
Ons, ek weet dat u dit beloof het en ek weet dat dit u moet wees.
It can't be that man, he's a man like I am, or like my husband, or like my son, or brother, or what more, see.
Dit kan nie daardie man wees nie. Hy is 'n man soos ek is, of soos my man, of soos my seun, of broer, of wat nog, sien.
But a gift is not something, a knife that you take and go do things with, a gift.
Maar 'n gawe is nie iets nie, 'n mes, wat jy vat en dinge mee gaan doen nie, 'n gawe nie.
Some of these days I'm going to get me a big tent and come to a city and just stay for about months at a time and teach them.
Een van hierdie dae gaan ek vir my 'n groot tent kry en na 'n stad kom en sommer daar bly vir maande aan een sien en net leer.
A gift is getting yourself out of the way so God can come in. See, what he shows, what he does.
'N gawe is om jouself uit die pad uit te kry sodat God kan inkom sien wat hy toon, wat hy doen.
A gift is not, I got power to do this, I got power.
'N gawe is nie, ek het die krag om dit te doen, ek het die krag nie.
Your power of a gift is get yourself out of the way.
Jou krag van 'n gawe is om jouself uit die pad uit te kry.
And the gift that God has given operates to that then, see, after you're out of the way. See?
En die gawe wat God jou gegee het, opereer dan daardeur, sien, nadat jy uit die pad uit is, sien.
Now I can't make him tell me nothing. He has to do it.
Nou, ek kan hom nie vir my iets laat vertel nie. Hy moet dit doen.
Now, at the same time, I'm real late.
Nou, om tyd te bespaar, ek's regtig laat.
But come here, lady. I want you to stand right here.
Maar kom hier, dame. Ek wil hê jy moet net hier staan.
I was speaking a few moments ago about a woman at the well.
Ek het 'n paar oomblikke gelede gepraat oor 'n vrou by die put.
Was you here last evening?
Was jy gisteraand hier?
You wasn't here.
Jy was nie hier nie.
Have you ever been one of the meetings before? Never been before.
Was jy ooit tevore in een van die byeenkomste gewees? nooit tevore gewees nie.
It's the first time. We're strangers. She wasn't even here last night. Never had instructions on it. Nothing but just stand here.
Dit is haar eerste keer. Ons is vreemdelinge. Sy was nie eens gisteraand hier nie. Het nooit instructies daaroor gehad nie. Niks maar, sta net hier.
Now, we are standing. You remember the story of the woman at the well?
Nou staan ons. Onthou jy die story van die vrou by die put?
It's a little panoramic, something like this, and a man and a woman met for the first time in life.
Dit was 'n klein toneeltjie, iets soos die. En die man en die vrou het vir al eerste keer in die lewe ontmoet.
Now, this woman was in, she was in shame.
Nou, hierdie vrou was in, sy was in skande.
She had married too many times, and she was living with a man she wasn't married to, and it was a very bad thing.
Sy het te veel kere getrou, en sy het met 'n man saamgeleef, met wie sy nie getroud was nie, en dit was 'n baie slechte ding.
And Jesus spoke to her.
En Jesus het met haar gepraat.
Now, you remember he said in St. John 5:19, verily, verily, I say unto you, the Son can do nothing in himself but what he sees the Father doing. That doeth the Son likewise.
Nou, julle onthou, hy het gesê in Johannes 5:19, voorwaar, ek sê vir julle, die Seun kan niks uit homself doen nie, maar wat hy die Vader sien doen, dit doen die Seun ook so.
Therefore, Jesus never performed one thing without first seeing it in a vision, or he told something wrong there.
Daarom, Jesus het nooit een ding verrig sonder om dit eers in 'n visioen te sien nie. Anders het hy daar iets verkeerds gesê.
The Son does nothing till he sees the Father do it first.
Die Seun doen niks totdat hy die Vader dit eers sien doen nie.
Now hears him, sees him.
Nie om hoor nie, om dit sien doen.
And then the Father, he had need to go by Samaria.
En dan die Vader, hy het 'n behoefte gehad om deur Samaria te gaan.
He was going to Jericho, but he went up to Samaria at the city of Sychar.
Hy was na Jericho op pad, maar hy het na Samaria gegaan, die stad Sychar.
And he met this woman, and he began to talk to her until he found where her trouble was.
En hy het hierdie vrou ontmoet, en hy het met haar begin praat totdat hy gevind het waar haar probleem was.
Then he told her trouble, and quickly, her in that condition, she recognized that was the sign of the Messiah.
Toe het hy vir haar vertel wat haar probleem is, en gou, sy in daardie toestand, het sy besef dat dit die teken van die Messias is.
Well, if that's him yesterday, it'd be the same one today, if he's the same yesterday, today, forever.
Wel, as dit hy gister is, sal dit dieselfde een vandag wees, as hy gister, vandag, en vir altyd dieselfde is.
Is that true, audience?
Is dit waar gehoor?
Now, we are meeting for our first time.
Sien, nou ons ontmoet vir ons eerste keer.
I'm not he, and you're not she, but he still is God.
Ek is nie hy nie, en jy is nie sy nie, maar hy is steeds God.
That's right.
Dis reg, sien?
Now, if you can have faith in what I'm saying in the Word, I'll never say nothing what's in this Word.
Nou, as jy geloof kan hê in wat ek sê in die Woord, ek sal nooit iets sê wat nie in hierdie Woord is nie.
He might do things outside of that word, but just as long as he does that, I know it's right.
Hy kan dalk dinge buite daardie woord doen, maar solank as hy net dit doen, weet ek, dis dan reg, sien?
And now, you don't know me, I don't know you.
En nou, jy ken my nie, ek ken jou nie.
So therefore, if you were sick, and I laid hands up on you and hollered, like that great warrior, Brother Roberts, or some of those, Brother Allen, or some of those men.
So daarom, as jy siek sou wees, en ek het hande op jou gelê en geskree, soos daardie groot stryder, Bro Roberts, of party van hulle, Bro Allen, of party van daardie manne.
Lay hands up on you and say, Hallelujah, the Lord heals you. That's good. You believe that, it'll work.
Lay jou hande op en sê, Hallelujah, die Here genees jou, dis goed. Jy glo dit, en dit sal werk, sien?
But now what if he stands here and tells something that you have done, or some reason that you're sick, or something that's happened down through life, or something you ought not have done?
Sien, maar nou wat as hy hier staan en sê iets wat jy gedoen het, of een of ander rede dat jy siek is, of iets wat daar deur die lewe gebeur het, of iets wat jy nie moes gedoen het nie.
Oh, that you know that had to be right, right through your mind. That's right.
Dat jy kon weet dat dit reg moet wees. Heeltemal duidelik dan in jou gemoed. Dis reg.
Would it yours out there?
Sou dit in julle sin daar?
Now what am I talking to the woman about?
Nou waaroor praat ek met die vrou?
See, I never kept on that message and I got the perseverance, see? It would change me into preaching.
Sien, Ek het nooit by daardie boodskap vandaan gebly nie. Ek het by volharding uitgekom. Sien, dit sou my na preek laat verander het.
Now I had to come back to discernment, relaxing myself, getting William Branham over on the side.
En moet nou na onderskeiding terugkom, myself laat ontspan, William Branham een kant toe kry.
How many ever seen that picture was taken here in Houston?
Hoeveel het ooit daardie foto gesien wat hier in Houston geneem is?
It's here, it's out front here now.
En julle, dis hier, dis nou hier voor, sien?
That's hanging right beside between me and the woman right now.
Dit hang net langs aan, tussen my en die vrou, nou net.
They're just kneeling right around.
Daar is dit, maar reg in die ronde.
If a woman wanted to witness to it, she knows in the last few seconds there has been something like a real sweet feeling.
As die vrou daarvan wil getuig, sy weet, in die laaste paar sekondes was daar iets soos 'n regte aangename gevoel.
That's right, raise up your hand.
As dit reg is, steek jou hand op.
See, I'm looking right at it. Seems like living in another dimension. I'm watching it to the woman.
Sien, ek kyk reg daarna. Sien, dis soos in 'n ander dimensie te lewe. Ek hou dit dop deur die vrou.
Now, the lady, one thing, she's extremely nervous.
Nou, die dame, een ding, sy is uitermate senuweeagtig.
And that's what you want me to pray for.
En dis waarvoor jy wil hê ek moet bid.
And that's just natural calls right now because of this time of life that you're living in, getting this age and so forth. That makes you nervous.
En dis net natuurlike oorsake tans vanweë hierdie tyd van die lewe waarin jy leef op hierdie ouderdom en sovoorts. Dit maak jou senuweeagtig.
Another thing, you've got something in your side. It's like little pockets of air like gathers in your side.
Nog iets, jy het iets in jou sy. Dis was klein lugsakkies soos kom in jou sy by mekaar.
Is dit reg?
Raise up your hand. That's a statement from the doctor.
Nou, is dit reg? Steek jou hand op as daardie.
Now, see, now, there that is again. Somebody saying he get...
Sin, nou sin, nou daar is dit weer. Iemand sê, hy het geraai.
I'm going to call who that is one of these days, see? Don't be...
Jy, ek gaan sê wie dit is, een van hierdie dae, sin. Moet dit nie doen nie.
You can't hide yourself now, remember?
Jy kan jouself nou nie verberg nie, onthou, sin.
The word is here itself, not me, friend. I'm just your brother. But the word is here.
Die woord, dis hier self. Nie ek nie, vriend. Ek's net jou broer, maar die woord is hier.
Here, she's a good person. Let's see if I guess that.
Hier, sy is 'n goeie mens. Laat ons sien of ek dit geraai het.
I don't know now what to say. It'll have to come through that tape, for I know.
Ek weet nou nie wat ek gesê het nie. Dit sal deur daardie band moet kom, want ek weet dit.
Just a moment. Yes. Yes, she gets nervous, which that's a call from a time or age and things.
No, net 'n oomblik. Ja, sy raak senuweeagtig, wat veroorsaak is van 'n tyd, haar ouderdom en dinge.
She's, and then another thing, you've had an operation.
Sês, en dan nog 'n ding, jy het 'n operasie gehad.
And that was a female affair some time ago, that's right.
En dit was 'n vroulike saak. 'N ruk gelede, dis reg.
That's made you nervouser than ever. That's right, isn't it? Mm-hmm. That's right.
Dit het jou senuweeagtiger as ooit gemaak. Dis reg, is dit nie? Dis reg.
And that made you nervous because at this time of life made you more nervous.
En dit het jou senuweeagtiger gemaak, want op hierdie tyd van die lewe het jou senuweeagtiger gemaak.
I think I'm guessing. Here's another thing.
Nou, dink jy ek raai dit? Hier is nog iets.
There's a girl with you. Yes. A little girl.
Daar is 'n dogter by jou, klein dogtertjie.
And she's here and she's suffering with mumps.
En sy is hier en sy lê aan pampoentjies.
Yes, that right?
Is dit reg?
Sit
daar.
And there's a woman, another woman, a friend of yours, and she's got mental oppression, like nervous and mental.
En daar's 'n vrou, 'n ander vrou, 'n vriend van jou. En sy het verstandelike beklemming, soos senuweeagtig en dan verstandelik.
Is dat reg?
Is dit reg?
Now when you go back, lay a handkerchief upon him, mumps will leave and she'll get over, you'll be well. Go leave it in the name of the Lord.
Nou, as jy teruggaan, lê daar die sakdoek op hulle. Die pampoentjies sal weggaan en sy sal daar oorkom en jy sal gesond word. Gaan glo in die naam van die Here Jesus.
You believe?
Glo julle?
That was Jesus yesterday. That's Jesus today.
Dit was Jesus gister. Dis Jesus vandag.
You have to know that somebody, see, somebody has.
Julle moet weet dat dit iemand is, sien? Ja, iemand het.
Now there, look, that was behind, see.
Nou, daar, kyk, dit was agter my, sien?
See, it's not, I couldn't do that. You know it's got to be some power, don't you?
Sien, dis nie, ek kon dit nie doen nie. Julle weet, dit moet een of ander krag wees, dan nie?
You believe it's the Lord Jesus according to his promise?
Glo julle, dis die Here Jesus volgens sy belofte?
Lord bless you.
Die Here seën julle.
How do you do, amen? I'm a stranger to you also.
Aangename kennis, dame. Ek is ook 'n vreemdeling vir jou.
I don't know. You've never seen me in my life. We're strangers.
Ek ken jou nie. Ek het jou nog nooit in my lewe gesien nie. Ons is vreemdelinge.
This is our first time meeting, as far as I know.
Dit is ons eerste ontmoeting, sover ek weet.
But now, if the Lord Jesus should tell me something about yourself, that something like that lady there, whatever it was, would you believe it? It was the Lord Jesus instead of.
Maar nou, as die Here Jesus my iets oor jou sou vertel, dat iets soos daardie dame daar, wat dit ook al was, sal jy glo dat dit die Here Jesus is in plaas van.
It wouldn't be me, you know.
Dit sou nie ek wees nie, weet jy?
And now, you could like the Pharisees say, it's Beelzebub, an evil spirit.
En nou, sou jy kon sê, soos die Fariseërs, dis Beelzebub, 'n bose gees.
And because they said the spirit of God that was doing that work in him was an evil spirit, it was blaspheming against the Holy Spirit, which should never be forgiven when this comes in this day.
En omdat hulle gesê het, die gees van God, wat daar die werk in hom gedoen het, is 'n bose gees. Was dit laster teen die Heilige Gees, wat nooit vergewe sal word, wanneer die in hierdie dag kom nie.
That's the reason this nation stands in judgment today.
Dis waarom hierdie nasie vandag in die oordeel staan.
It's nothing left for it but judgment.
Daar's niks oor behalwe net oordeel nie.
It's full of jack rubies and so forth. So it can't be nothing else happened to it but judgment.
Dis vol jack rubies en so forth. So daar kan niks anders daarmee gebeur. As net oordeel nie.
Now, you're ill.
Nou, jy is ongesteld.
You've been to a doctor.
Jy was na 'n dokter.
He really would advise an operation.
Hy wou regtig 'n operasie aanbeveel.
That operation is on the colon.
Daardie operasie is aan die kolon.
That's true, isn't it?
Dit is waar, is dit nie?
Here's another thing. You're desperately in need of a spiritual.
Hier is nog 'n ding. Jy het desperaat nodig 'n geestelike.
You haven't been feeling right. You kind of washed away a little and you want to come back.
Jy het nie lekker gevoel nie. Jy het soort van weggespoel 'n bietjie en jy wil terugkom.
Well, you're back now.
Wel, jy is nou terug.
I don't believe in all your heart and you'll get well in Jesus Christ.
Nou gaan, glo met jou hele hart en jy sal gesond word in Jesus Christus se naam.
Your sins are forgiven.
Jou sondes word jou vergewe. Nou gaan, glo.
Now I was said sins forgiven. He said that. See, it wasn't me. It's him.
Nou, ek het nooit gesê sondes word vergewe nie. Hy het dit gesê, sien? Dit was nie ek nie. Dit was hy, sien?
You believe?
Glo julle?
Now I ought to make the rest of you just know that's him here.
Nou, dit behoort die res van julle sommer te laat weet. Dis hy wat hier is.
Isn't that right?
Is dit nie reg nie?
If you just believe.
As julle net sou glo.
Just have faith, don't doubt. Be reverent and believe God.
Julle moet net geloof hê. Moenie twyfel nie. Wees eerbiedig en glo God.
Now, see, you're in his presence.
Nou, sien, julle is in sy teenwoordigheid.
Now, if one of those discernments made the Son of God say virtue went out, what do you think it would do to me, a sinner saved by his grace?
Nou, as een van daardie onderskeidings die Seun van God laat sê het, krag het uitgegaan, wat dink julle sou dit aan my doen, 'n sondaar wat deur sy genade gered is, sien?
You know what it would be.
Dit sou wees, julle weet wat dit sou wees.
Just a moment. Well, it isn't a woman.
Net 'n oomblik. Dit is nie die vrou nie.
Say you that were just healed there, lady, going back to your seat. Look to me just a moment.
Say, Jy wat pas genees is, daar, dame, wat na jou sitplek teruggaan, kyk net 'n oomblik na my.
There's a man sitting right in front of you there that has sinus trouble. Sitting right there.
Daar is 'n man wat daar reg voor jou sit, wat sinus probleme het, wat net daar sit.
Yeah. You believe that God will make you well? You do? All right.
Ja, glo jy dat God jou gesond sal maak? Glo jy? Goed.
Tell me what he touched.
Sê my, wat hy aangeraak het.
I don't know a man never seen him in my life.
Ek ken die man nie. Het hom nog nooit in my lewe gesien nie.
If that's right, wave your hand if we're strangers to one another.
As dit reg is, wave your hand as ons vreemdelinge vir mekaar is.
Now look, if you might know something else, his wife standing by him there. You believe God can tell me what's wrong with her?
Nou kyk, sodat jy nog iets kan weet, sy vrou wat daar by hom sit, glo jy God kan vir my sê wat met haar verkeerd is?
Will you believe me to be his prophet or his servant? Will you do it?
Sal jy glo ek is sy profeet of sy diensknegt? Sal jy dit doen?
She's got hay fever. That's right, raise up your hand, lady.
Sê dit, wakewors. As dit reg is, steek jou hand op, dame. Goed.
Now if you won't believe, you touch something, believe not, believe it.
Nou, as jy albei sal glo, jy het iets aangeraak, glo nou, en dit sal jy verlaat.
You believe God?
Glo jy God?
No doubt. Have faith in God.
Moet nie twyfel nie, hê geloof in God.
Here's a man. I've never seen this man. He's quite a bit younger than I, and I've never seen him before.
Hier is 'n man. Ek het hierdie man nog nooit gesien nie. Hy sê julle eentjie jonger as ek. En ek het hom nog nooit tevore gesien nie.
If we're strangers, sir, to each other, raise up your hand.
As ons vreemdelinge is, meneer, vir mekaar, steek jou hande op. Goed.
I've never seen him.
Ek het hom nog nooit gesien nie.
Now let's take a picture in the Bible. Let's take when Jesus met Simon Peter.
Nou laat ons 'n prentjie neem in die Bybel. Laat ons neem toe Jesus Simon Petrus ontmoet het.
I'd imagine him being a man something about that age, his hair thinning when Jesus met him.
Ek sou my kon voorstel, hy was 'n man van omtrent daardie ouderdom. Sy hare het begin dun word toe Jesus hom ontmoet het.
I watched him talk to him.
Nou kyk, hy het met hom gepraat.
Now, if I don't know the man, never seen him, both of us with our hands up, we're total strangers to each other.
Nou, as ek die man nie ken nie, hom nog nooit gesien het nie, beide van ons met ons hande omhoog, ons is totale vreemdelinge vir mekaar.
Now the others is women. Let's see about this man.
Nou, die ander was vroue. Laat ons sien wat van hierdie man.
Now you look at me just a moment, as your brother.
Kyk jy nou na my, net vir 'n oomblik, as jou broer.
And now, if the Lord would say something that you have done, or something that you ought to have done, or ought not have done, or whatever it is, you'll know whether it's the truth or not.
En nou, as die Here iets sou sê, wat jy gedoen het, of iets wat jy behoort te gedoen het, of nie behoort te gedoen het nie, of wat dit ook al is, sal jy weet of dit die waarheid is of nie.
You know.
Jy sou weet.
And then, if he can tell you what's wrong with you, or something is on your mind, what your sickness is, or something like that, tell you something, that you know what's the truth or not.
En dan as hy jou kan vertel wat met jou verkeerd is, of iets wat op jou gemoed lê, wat jou siekte is, of so iets, jou iets vertel wat jy sal weet of dit die waarheid is of nie.
Then if he can tell you what has been, and you know what's true or not, if he tells you what's going to be, then you know it's got to be true.
Dan as hy jou kan sê wat was, en jy weet of dit waar is of nie, as hy jou vertel wat gaan wees, dan sal jy weet dit moet waar wees.
Now would that make everyone in here just take my time with this man and talk with this is the first.
Nou, sal dit almal hier binne laat? Neem maar my tyd met hierdie man en praat met hom. Dit is die eerste een.
And you look at this way just a moment as we talk.
Nou kyk jy hiernatoe, net 'n oomblik soos ons praat.
May the Lord help me now.
Mag die Here my nou help.
And you believe what the Bible says is true.
En glo jy wat die Bybel sê is waar?
You believe that this is the hour that Jesus is to come, that the church has come from justification, sanctification, baptism of the Holy Spirit, just like a pyramid, like that coming.
Glo jy dat dit die uur is dat Jesus moet kom, dat die kerk gekom het van regverdigmaking, heiligmaking, doop van die Heilige Gees, net soos die piramide, soos dit wat kom.
And now the top stone is going to have to be so perfect till when the headstone comes, it has to blend right with it.
En nou gaan die boonste steen so perfect moet wees dat wanneer die kopsteen kom, dit net daarbij sal moet inpas.
The ministry has started out like this and has come to the minority all the time, getting smaller groups and smaller groups, until finally the stone meets with the building.
Die bediening moet so begin en net die hele tyd na die minderheid kom, kleiner groepe kry en kleiner groep, totdat uiteindelik die steen in die gebouw ontmoet.
He's the headstone, takes the whole building with him, which is the church.
Hy is die kopsteen, neem die hele gebouw met hom, wat die kerk is.
All them will raise up, come back from the first watch on to the seventh, and all go in the rapture.
Hulle allemaal sal opstaan, reg uit de rug van hier die eerste waak af, daar tot die sevende, en allemaal in die wegraping gaan.
Each one had their day allotted to them, they had their reformers and founders and so forth all down through.
Jaken het hulle dag vir hulle bestem gehad, en hulle het al hervormers en stichters gehad, en sovoorts recht daardeer.
In this last day it come into an eagle again, which is back in the prophetic age, to bring this together.
En in die laatste dag het het weer tot de arend gekom, wat de rug in die profetische eeuw is, om dit bij mekaar te bring.
You believe that the word and stone are coming on.
Gloe je dit, die woord en steen, die een wat kom?
You have a very fine feeling to you, sir.
Jy het een baie goeie gevoel omtrent jou, meneer.
Now what's your trouble? You've had an accident.
Nou, wat jou probleem is, jy het een ongeluk gehad.
In that accident you were gassed with carbon oxide gas.
En daar die ongeluk is jy vergas met koolstofmonoxidgas.
That is true.
Dit is waar.
It poisoned you.
Dit het jou vergiftig.
It poisoned you in your liver and you had trouble with that.
Dit het jou in jou lever vergiftig. En jy het daarmee probleme gehad.
You had trouble with your stomach.
Jy het probleme met jou maag gehad.
You had trouble with your heart.
Jy het probleme met jou hart gehad.
And it's made you so nervous until you built yourself in a complex.
En dit het jou so senuweeagtig gemaak dat jy vir jouself in 'n kompleks ingebou het.
You're poor, must go back to work.
Jy is arm, moet terug gaan werk toe.
But you're afraid to go back to work. You're afraid of that carbon oxide gas.
Maar jy is bang om terug te gaan werk toe. Jy is bang vir daar die koolstofmonoksiedgas.
But it's going to be all right.
Maar dit gaan in orde wees.
Now remember, if Jesus Christ will tell me who you are.
Nou, onthou, as Jesus Christus vir my sal sê wie jy is.
Now them things is true, wasn't it?
Sal, nou, daar die dinge is waar, is hulle nie.
If he'll tell me who you are, will you accept it and know and go on back and be of a good cheer? Will you do it? Your name is Mr. Wagner.
As hy my sal sê wie hy is, sal jy dit aanvaar en weet en teruggaan en goeie moed hê? Sal jy dit doen? Jou naam is meneer Wagner.
Go on back on your road.
Gaan terug op jou pad.
You believe now?
Glooi julle nou?
With all your heart you believe?
Met julle hele hart glooi julle?
If thou canst believe, all things are possible to them that believe.
As jy kan glo, is alles. Alles is moontlik vir hulle wat glo.
Now, do you believe that God will heal that female trouble for you?
Glo jy nou dat God daar die vroulike probleme vir jou sal genees?
Well, let's go all across the platform.
No!
Nou gaan maar net voort oor die platform en sê, Amen. Sien, God sien jou.
Now lady, when you get up of a morning, you're stiff. You can't hardly move around very much. Arthritis.
Nou dame, wanneer jy soggens opstaan, is jy stijf. Jy kan kwalik baie rondbeweeg, artritis.
But you believe God heals arthritis?
Maar glo jy dat God artritis genees?
Why go on your road saying thank you, Lord?
Goed, gaan op jou weg, sê dankie, Here.
Well, that's what caused your arthritis.
Goed, meneer, dis wat jou artritis veroorsaak het, sien, is jou senuwees.
If thou canst believe, all things are possible. But first, you've got to believe it.
As jy kan glo, is alle dinge moontlik, maar eers moet jy dit glo.
What do you think, sir? Do you believe with all your heart?
Wat dink jy, meneer? Glo jy met jou hele hart?
You believe God heals heart trouble and makes you well?
Glo jy God genees hartprobleme en maak jou gesond?
All right, go on your own, say thanks to Lord Jesus.
Goed, gaan op jou weg, sê dankie, Here Jesus.
Now lady, you're shattered. That means cancer.
Nou, dame, jy is omskadu. Dit beteken kanker.
You believe God will heal cancer?
Glo jy God sal kanker genees?
Or accept it and go on your own saying thank you dear God and believe with all your heart.
Goed, aanvaard dit en gaan op jou weg, sê, dankie, liewe God, en glo met jou hele hart.
God can heal stomach trouble or anything else, do you believe that?
God kan maagprobleme genees of enigiets anders, glo jy dit?
Alright, go on your own, rejoice and say thank you.
Goed, gaan op jou weg en juig, sê, dankie, Here Jesus.
You believe God will heal your female trouble, that dripping?
Glo jy God sal jou vroulike probleme genees, daardie gedrip?
Alright, go on your own, say praise the Lord, do it all your heart.
Goed, gaan op jou weg, sê, prijs die Heere, glo met jou hele hart.
You believe God heals sinus and asthma and all this stuff makes you well?
Glo jy God genees sinus en asthma en al hierdie goed, maak jou gezond?
Go on your road, rejoice and say, thank you dear God.
Gaan op jou weg, juichend, sê, dankie, lieve God.
What if I didn't say nothing, you just lay hands on you, believe it?
Wat daarvan, as ek niks vir jou gesê het nie, net hande op jou geleed, sou jy dit glo?
In the name of the Lord Jesus be healed.
In die naam van die Here Jesus word genees.
Believe with all your heart.
Glo met jou hele hart.
Come lady. You believe with all your heart?
Kom dame, glo jy met jou hele hart?
Anemia condition, heart trouble. You believe God will make you well?
Bloedarmoede toestand en hartprobleme. Glo jy dat God jou gezond sal maak?
Did you go on your own say thank you Lord Jesus and be made well?
As jy dit doen, gaan op jou weg sê, dankie Here Jesus en word gezond gemaak.
Alright sir. Come lady.
Goed, meneer, kom dame.
You believe God heals diabetes and makes people well from diabetes?
Glo jy God genees suikersiekte en maak mense gezond van suikersiekte?
Then go on your own say thank you. Believe with all your heart.
Gaan dan op jou weg, sê, dankie. Glo met jou hele hart, sien.
God heals nervousness and stomach trouble too.
God genees senuweeachtigheid en maagprobleme ook.
You believe he makes you well?
Glo jy, hy maak jou gezond?
Go on your road rejoicing, eat your supper, be of a good courage.
Gaan op jou weg, juichend. Eet jou aandete en hou goeie moed.
Come. A nervous stomach too, you believe God will make you well?
Kom, een senuweeachtige maag ook. Glo jy God, sal jou gezond maak?
Go on your road, eat and be well, be with all your heart.
Gaan op jou weg en eet en word gezond gemaak. Glo met jou hele hart.
You have a little heart flutter, but also your thigh got arthritis.
Jy het 'n bietjie hartfladdering, maar jy het ook soort van artritis.
You believe God will make you well?
Glo jy God sal jou gezond maak?
Go on your road rejoice and say thank you Lord.
Gaan op jou weg en juig en sê dankie Here.
A nervous stomach causes a peptic ulcer and things.
'N senuweeachtige maag wat die maagseer en dinge veroorsaak.
You believe God will make you well, heal you?
Glo jy dat God jou gezond sal maak en jou sal genees?
Go on your road and say thank you, Lord, you may well.
Gaan op jou weg en sê, dankie Here en word gezond gemaak.
You got many things, a lady's trouble, one of your great pains is a heart trouble, too much around your heart.
Jy het baie dinge, 'n dames probleme. Een van jou groot dinge is 'n hartprobleem, te veel om jou hart.
You believe God will make you well?
Glo jy God sal jou gezond maak?
Go on your road, rejoice and say thank you, Lord.
Gaan op jou weg en juig en sê, dankie Here.
You believe God heals arthritis?
Glo jy God genees arthritis?
Just keep on going, your arthritis will be done.
Gaan maar net voort en jou arthritis sal wegwees.
You believe with all your heart?
Glo jylle met jou hele hart?
Sure it does. Now some of you out in the audience.
Sien, sekerlik daardie. Nou, partij van jylle daar in die gehoor.
Now be reverent, be reverent. Just sit still, you believe with all your heart now.
Nou wees eerbiedig, sit net stil. Glo jylle nou met jylle hele hart.
Look this way. Believe with all your heart. Some of you people out there is not going to be in the prayer line.
Kyk hier na toe. Glo met julle hele hart. Sommige mense daar wat nie in die gebedsry gaan wees nie.
This little boy sitting out here. Little chubby fellow sitting right there.
Hierdie klein seentjie wat hier sit. Bonkige kereltjie wat net daar sit.
Don't you see that light over him?
Sien julle nie daardie lig oor hom nie?
The little fellow is suffering with a kidney trouble.
Die kereltjie ly aan 'n nierprobleem.
You believe that God will heal the kidney trouble, sonny?
Glo jy dat God die nierprobleem sal genees, seentjie?
You believe it?
Glo jy dit?
Alright, stand up on your feet and say, I believe it, and accept it.
Goed, staan op jou voete en sê, ek glo dit en aanvaard dit.
Alright, God bless you. Go
Goed, God seën jou, gaan op jou.
You believe with all your heart?
Glo jylle met jou hele hart?
If thou canst believe, all things are possible.
As jy kan glo, is alle dinge moontlik.
What about you? Just sit down there. Come up with the little boy and sit down.
Wat van jou wat pas daar gaan sit het, aangekom het met 'n seentjie en gaan sit het.
You believe in eye trouble, God will heal your eye trouble and make you well.
Glo jy, daardie oogprobleem, God sal jou oogprobleem genees en jou gesond maak.
You do? All right, you can have your healing too. All right.
Glo jy, goed, jy kan ook jou genesing kry, goed.
You just sit down at the right time, amen.
Jy het net op die regte oomblik gaan sit, amen.
Go right ahead, it's fine, that's good, all right, amen.
Gaan gerus voort, dis mooi, dis goed, goed, amen.
All right, the lady next to you there, she's got trouble with her head. Do you believe that God will heal your head trouble, lady?
Goed, die dame daar langs jou, sy het probleme met haar kop. Glo jy dat God jou kopprobleem sal genees, dame?
All right, your little girl there suffers with a mental trouble. That's right, isn't it?
Goed, jou dogtertjie daar lei aan 'n verstandelike probleem. Dis reg, is dit nie?
Lay your hand over on her and believe and she'll get well too.
Lay jou hand daar op haar en glo, en sy sal ook gesond word.
You believe that?
Glo jy dit?
This next lady sitting there, she's praying right next to it.
Hierdie volgende dame wat volgende sit, sy bid reg daar langs.
She's praying there because of a broke up home. Is that right, lady? Raise up your hand.
Sy bid daar vanweë 'n opgebreekte huis. Is dit reg, dame? Steek jou hand op.
Believe in your home will be restored again. Have faith.
Glo en jou huis sal weer herstel word. Jy moet geloof hê.
The lady sitting next to her has got a cyst.
Die dame wat langs haar sit, het 'n cyst.
Do you believe that God will heal that cyst, lady?
Glo jy dat God daardie cyst sal genees, dame?
Raise up your hand, accept it.
Steek jou hand op, aanvaard dit.
Lady sitting next to her's got throat trouble. Do you believe that God will heal your throat, lady? Raise up your hand.
Die dame wat langs haar sit, het keelprobleme. Glo jy dat God jou keel sal genees, dame? Steek jou hand op.
What's the matter with you people? Don't you see that Jesus Christ?
Wat is die probleem met julle mense? Sien julle nie dat Jesus Christus? Laat ons op ons voete staan. Staan op julle voete en aanvaar Jesus as jul geneesheer.
O Lamb of God, in the name of Jesus Christ, heal every person here for your glory.
O Lam van God, in die naam van Jesus Christus, genees elke persoon hier tot u glorie.